Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. It is really a privilege to have all of you in this webinar that's going to put some light on the impact of this COVID on women and girls in our state and also in India. All of us have actually got impacted by this COVID, which is very unprecedented. None of us had that experience also. And, apart from all the scientists, probably in this generation, there are very few people who had experienced a pandemic, and it is absolutely new for all of us and very obvious and very imperative that many of us do not have the coping strategy to cope with this kind of problems. Always any kind of disaster has a very bad impact on women and children specifically. And in this context, we at Odisha Vikas Conclave, we thought of actually taking this up, focusing on the life of women, how it has impacted women. It's welcome all of you on behalf of National Alliance of Women, on behalf of AINA, and also on behalf of Odisha Vikas Conclave. There are many more organizations who have been partnering with this. We are very fortunate to have prominent speakers and prominent personalities of our state. Professor Mitali Chinara, who is heading the economics department in Utkal University and also has a lot of experience on social issues. She was the former director of School of Women Studies also, coordinator of School of Women Studies. We have Professor Navanita Rath with us, who is heading the Department of Sociology and also she is the present coordinator of Women Studies department in Utkal University. We also have Ms. Pragya Paramita Bastia, who is a very young and dynamic activist, and right now is heading the Women Helpline, which is a very, very important portfolio she is handling at specifically at this point of time in the pandemic, when women have been actually looking for all this support system, and she is the one who has actually been handling it. So it will be really interesting to hear Pragya. So we have Pragya Bastia with us. We also have Mr. Dasiram Panda. Many of you know him as a developmental professional who has been working very intensely on the issues of child marriage in our state, not only in in the field, but also helping the government in bringing the policy lines together for these particular social problems, which we have not been able to actually, come out with. Also, during this pandemic, what we have seen is there is an increasing, trend of child marriage in our state. Almost 230 some odd child marriages got, prevented. I mean, the parents have decided to get these girls married who are not even 18, and somehow it managed to prevented, and I think Rasam is going to throw a lot of lights on that, and also would bring in his hands-on experience on dealing with these cases and also the consequences, and also the agency of the adolescent girls they have actually promoted in the field, which is fantastic in terms of the girls coming out and then just not preventing this, but also creating awareness on the issues of child marriage, which is very, very important at this point of time. So welcome all our delegates. It is really a proud privilege to have all of you, and thank you all very much. Within a very short span of time, you agreed to join us as a speaker and also going to speak on this particular issue.
But Lodita pa join karchanti. Lodita pa join karchanti.
Niladri, can you bring in Ladkappa to the forum also? I just would like to, before we get into our deliberation, I just would like to say, inform all our panelists and also the participants. We will speak in both English and Odia. All of us are Odia. There are some people who may not be, very well versed in Odia. So for them, this thing also can go on. And all our speakers are going to present their presentation in English. So if they deliver in Odia also, I think it will be understandable for all the people, those who do not understand Odia at least. okay, he has not joined, she hasn't joined it. Since it's okay, and the library just you know, keep looking at it, and if she is there, then you can bring in her to the platform. ମୁଁ ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କୁ ଏହା କହିବା ପାଇଁ ଚାହୁଁଥିଲି ଓଡ଼ିଶା ବିକାଶ କନକ୍ଲେଭ ହେଉଛି ଗୋଟେ କନଗ୍ଲୋମରେସନ ଅଫ୍ ଅଲ୍ ଦି ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ ଅଣ୍ଡର ଦ ବ୍ୟାନର ଅଫ୍ ଓଡ଼ିଶା ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ଇନିସିଏଟିଭ ପ୍ରତି ଦୁଇବର୍ଷରେ ଥରେ ଆମେମାନେ ଗୋଟେ କନକ୍ଲେଭ କରନ୍ତି ଯେଉଁଥିରେ ବି ଟକ୍ ଅବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ଇସ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଇନ୍ ଆର୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହାଉ ଦ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରଫେସନାଲ୍ସ କମ୍ ଟୁଗେଦର ଟୁ ୟୁ ନୋ ଲାଇକ୍ ବ୍ରିଙ୍ଗ ସମ୍ ଚେଞ୍ଜେସ୍ ଇନ୍ ଆର୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଭେରିୟସ୍ ଆସ୍ପେକ୍ଟସ୍ There are 17, there are 19 tracks that we had discussed in last time in the conclave actually happened, and under the Odisha Development Initiative, every 2 years we have the you know conclave actually get organized, and the next year we release a report. Last year we could not actually release the report which was supposed to be released this year, and also the conclave had to happen this year, but because of the pandemic, we had to you know like thought of this. Online you know as a method as a you know the for our streaming for all these things, so we this morning we had released the Odisha development report also, and for the 2020 we actually had 3-4 you know track discussion. In the morning we had education, we had fantastic deliberation on the education. They had actually focused on how the schools are getting you know closed, which is going to become a bigger problem in our state because of the pandemic. Now for 8 or 9 months the schools are closed, and when the schools are going to be actually open, many of the students may not actually join in, specifically the girl students. I'm pretty sure Professor Navanita Rath and Professor Mitali Chinara is going to focus on this particular issue, how it is actually going to impact our girls and women in our state. So that was not the one stream where we had the discussion. We also had the discussion on the natural agriculture. Then we also had the discussion on the migration. So which this discussion had already happened in the first half of this trip, of this day, and in the afternoon we are having you know this discussion, how the pandemic has actually impacted the life of women and girls in our state. So without delaying much, I would request our first panelist, Professor Mitali Chinara, who has been working as the head of the Department of Economics, Economics in Utkal University, to speak on her issues. Specifically, she's going to focus on, you know, how the life of women has been actually affected, specifically from the economic point of view, from the economy. I mean the life and livelihood of women actually how it has got affected. She's going to speak mostly about that. It's the impact of pandemic on lives and livelihoods of women and policy imperatives through the gender lens. So this is a perfect you know like subject line to start this deliberation on. So with this, I would like to invite Mitali Chinara to take up
this web space problem. Over to you, Mitali. Thank you so much, Sneha. Esteemed panelists and very dear participants, I am really privileged to have having got this opportunity to share some of my thoughts. And though it has been, we didn't get much of a time to prepare. But the thing is that the issue of impact of this particular disaster, we can call it pandemic disaster, on women is something very close to our hearts. Therefore, I'd like to speak on this from an economic point of view, as I have a is it visible?
Yes, Mitali, go ahead.
Okay, so I would pitch my talk on this. I'll be talking basically about the impact of the pandemic on lives and livelihoods of women. And it's not sufficient to talk about the problems. It is not sufficient to raise the issues. What is more important is that we have to talk about solutions. So in terms of solutions, I would like to talk about what are the policy imperatives and how they can be viewed through a gender lens. So if I come to, how do I make it full screen?
On your screen at the bottom, you can see
slide.
Yeah, slide show.
Bottom there is a slide show. Yeah. I can't see.
Just a second.
Hello. I have got it. It's done. Okay, done. So, impact of pandemic on lives and livelihoods of women. Policy imperatives through gender lens. That will be the basically my focus of talk. Now, if I come to, I would like to start my talk with a quotation from the managing director of IMF, who happens to be a woman at this point of time, who says that if you are to wake up tomorrow with men and women being equal, world's health wealth would be $172 trillion bigger. But gender equality does not fall from the sky. It needs to be written into policies and fought for. Gender equality does not fall. You cannot just sit tight and just hope gender equality to materialize. It has to be written into policies and fought for. And Melinda Gates from the Bill, famous Bill and Bill Gates Foundation says that COVID-19 is gender blind, but not gender neutral. IMF anticipates the worst economic crisis since Great Depression, and it projects that over 170 countries will experience a negative per capita income growth in 2020. And World Bank estimates the global economy to shrink by 5.2%. And what is important, what is worrying, is that 60 million people are likely to be pushed into extreme poverty. When you're talking about poverty, there is a concept we all are familiar with. We talk about feminization of poverty. That is, incidence of poverty on women is more severe than on men. And if you talk in 2020, when we are exactly 25 years after what we call the Beijing platform, declaration of the at the Beijing platform, 25 years, we should have had, this should have been a turning point. But many people, especially the, what do you say, the people who are working on this field, they're fearing that instead of marching ahead, ame aguku bodhiba jagare hue to ame Amara progressa, not only it is going to be, it might be stopped. There are threats, there are chances of it being stopped. There may be, we may be going back, and many of the progress that has been already achieved may be, we may be losing that, the advantage that we have had. Now, this pandemic, as we know, is putting a stress, and it is widening socioeconomic divides, and it is also changing the priorities. And what is happening is that it is exposing the cracks and faults of the society along lines of gender, race, caste, and class. Whatever faults, whatever weaknesses the society has along those issues, those lines are getting exposed. Now, the gender impact are found, according to the famous journal Lancet, the gender impact are not found in the numbers of affected or dead, but in the gender differentiated fallout of the control measures and the policies to revive the economy after the pandemic is over. The differentiated impact of disaster on men and women is primarily caused by the existing gender inequalities. Why there is a difference? As Melinda Gates would say, it is not gender, it is gender blind, but the impact is not the same as on men and women. It is because of gender inequalities that we see that the impact on men and women is happens to be different. And what is important is that history teaches us that disease outbreaks, whether you talk about AIDS to Zika to Ebola, play out with a certain grim predictability. That is, it affects the women. Any kind of disaster, be it natural disaster, be it a pandemic, it affects the women more to a greater extent than the men. I would like to quote here a study from 2007 by the London School of Economics, which took up a sample of 141 countries over a period of 1981 to 2002. And it showed that natural disaster and the subsequent impact on average, kill women at an earlier age than men. And it is related to women's lower socioeconomic status. That is with regard to gender differentiated impact of natural disasters on women. Exactly similarly, in 2014 Ebola outbreak, it had a disproportionate impact on women. A study by Oxfam International and UN Women after the outbreak showed that during the virus spread, the unemployment rates tripled both for men and women. But what happened was that men's income tend to come back quickly, whereas women took much longer to recover. So this clearly shows that historically, over a period, there is a greater impact of all kinds of natural impact on women. Now, if I talk about impact on women, COVID-19 crisis is likely likewise anticipated to hit women's employment rates hard, unemployment rates hard, especially in the most vulnerable economies. The question arises as to why do we expect a disproportionate impact on women? Now, this is attributable to several causes. The first cause is that women dominate the social sector. Women dominate the social sector and they make up 70% of the health workforce. Women mostly are employed in sectors which are hit hard, like the service sector, which includes retail, hospitality, tourism, education, social work, etc. And these are sectors which require face-to-face interaction, and these are very hard hit during the social distancing that we are talking about. Whether you talk about vaccine or not, they are saying that we have to continue with the use of the norms of social distancing. We have to continue with masks. We have to continue with sanitization. All these will continue, and these social distancing is going to hit hard the sectors where we find mostly women are employed. And there are many sectors like this: hospitality, tourism, education, social work, etc., where working from home is not an option. You cannot work from home in the hospitality sector. There is nothing called work from home. Now, they are also at the forefront of COVID-19 response, navigating the severely strained healthcare system. The majority of the unpaid or poorly paid community health workers, which includes our ASHA and Anganwadi workers, many of whom are currently, they were performing and they continue to perform the critical work, many times without the necessary protective equipment and hygiene facilities, are women. Now, the second factor which causes disproportionate impact on women is that women are more likely to be employed in the informal sector, and this is more so in low-income countries. Now, this 58% of the women are in the informal economy with little or very or almost no social protection. This is at the world level. And the percentage in India in the social sector is what we say, it is as high as 94%. So these are the women who are employed in the informal sector, and they face job losses. There is no social security to talk about. And hence, these are the women who are going to lose their employment. Informal economy offers no protection. No protection through labor laws, no benefits like pension, health insurance, and so on. Now, the third factor is that, very important, women tend to do more unpaid housework than men. This is a study. This is not from hearsay. This is a study where we say that by default, the unpaid family caregivers are women. And they put in 2.7 hours per day more work in more unpaid work than men. Now, there is an argument by feminists that the gamut of reproductive tasks is needed for societies to function smoothly and for the next generation of the labor force to be born and nurtured. But the cost of these social needs are mostly borne by the women. It has been estimated in 2019 that the imputed value of this unpaid reproductive work by women was equivalent to $10.9 trillion, which is more than the earning of the top 50 firms in the world in 2018. This is a study. The monetary imputation is useful to understand the sheer magnitude of the unpaid work. Now, if you talk about the unpaid work in developing countries, unpaid work consists of the full range of reproductive labor. But as above, as we have talked about, that is all those nurturing and all those caregiving work. But in addition, in underdeveloped economies or in developing economies, it also includes economic or productive work that is unpaid. Now, what is this economic productive work which is unpaid? This is work which is counted in the production boundary of the system of national accounts, or SNA as it's referred to as. But this is counted as work only when a man is performing it. women who are engaged in unpaid productive work, that is work routinely, recognized work distinct from domestic chores and care responsibilities, are typically working on family enterprises, on family market, on family farms, in rearing livestock or poultry, in making commodities for sale in the market, in family owned shops or workshops, on food orchards, farms, etc. And these economic livelihood generating, these are no doubt economic livelihood generating activities for the family, in which women participate in and contribute to, but are not paid and even not recognized as workers. What is more important is that women who do this, for example, in a household which consists of farmers, or a household where there is weaving household, women contribute. But apan je tanku pacharibe je apan kichhi rozgar kariba pai nijara ghara kama chhada au kichhi kama karuchanti ki, se stri loko mane nije kahibe na. So women, they themselves are not aware. So this is not counted. And this unpaid work is, so they have a large responsibility, bear the burden of unpaid household work, which not only includes the caregiving and nurturing, but also unpaid household work, which is economic in nature, but not counted. The fourth factor is that pandemic has put women at greater risk of losing human capital. What is happening is that in many developing countries, we see that young girls are forced to drop out of school and work to supplement household income. The Malala Fund report says that the share of girls not attending school nearly tripled in Liberia after the Ebola crisis. In any kind of crisis, girls dropping out of schools, out of education system, is very high. And girls are 25% less likely to re-enroll after a study found that girls are less likely to enroll by 25% in a study in Guinea. Now in India, for example, we see that there is, in the matrimony, Sneha was talking about child marriage. India study shows that leading matrimony websites has reported a 30% surge in new registrations. While the girls are dropping out of education, when the girls are dropping out of education, they suffer a permanent loss of human capital, sacrificing productivity growth and perpetuating a gender imbalance. And there, a vicious circle is set in motion. However, this kind of a situation, so therefore we say that the pandemic puts women at a greater risk. So this is a kind of a permanent loss, this is likely to become a permanent loss, because the probability of girls going back to the education for getting education or skill is much less than a boy child. Now the fifth is the gender digital divide, which puts women at a disadvantage where government and business services have moved online. It further accentuates gender inequality. It is usually believed that population who are excluded from the digital world is the most at risk of being left behind. For example, ame jetebele online class kotha kouchu ba online patha padha houchi, ame dekhuchu jo mananka pakhare smartphone tie nahi, jo manankara access nahi to internet, they are not able to access whatever studies are going on, whatever classes are going on. So naturally, they jo digital divide which exists. Now a study shows that more men than women use the internet. The global gender gap in internet usage grew from 11% in 2013 to 17% in 2019. And this divide is 43% in the least developed countries. So as we move on to less developed or developing economies, this gender digital divide accentuates. Ita adhika adhika hei jauchi. Awe digital divide jogu महिला माने स्त्री लोक माने गोटे पैंडेमिक रो जेते बळे आमे ऑनलाइन रो फोकस रहुची, गोटे वी आर मेनी बहुत कथा ऑनलाइन को मूव करुची, दे आर डिबार्ड फ्रॉम दिस एंटायर सिस्टम, दे आर बीइंग पुश्ड आउट ऑफ द मेनस्ट्रीम, पुश्ड आउट ऑफ द सिस्टम. एंड अनदर फैक्टर आई वुड से दैट फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन. Financial inclusion among the women is also relatively less. 65% of women and 72% of men had an account in a financial institution. This is a study of 2017. Just having an account, I agree that having an account is not financial inclusion. It is, they have to use the services, but having an account is the first step for financial inclusion. Now, if you talk about any kind of a shock, adaptability to the shock, how far you adapt, the changes are required, how far you can adapt to the shock depends to a large extent on the assets which are available. In general, women tend to have more limited access to assets, which includes financial assets, financial, physical, human, social, natural capital, such as land, credit, decision-making bodies, agricultural inputs, technology, extension, training services, which would all enhance their capacity to adapt. So any shock comes, any kind of a shock which you are subjected to what extent you can adapt and how what extent you can move ahead and absorb the shock depends on your access to assets, and women being devoid of assets, relatively less ownership of assets, they have little bit, therefore they will have limited adaptability as well. Now, if you talk about response, what is to be done? This is the problem. So we have to look at the solutions. Now, when you talk about the solutions, I would say that I would divide the solutions as to immediate solutions, which must be put in place. I would say that solutions which are relatively in the medium or in the long run. Now, if you talk about the immediate solutions, the first thing that has to be done is that the sexual and reproductive health care must be classified as essential services. During the close down, during the lockdown, what was evidenced was that only essential services were there and almost non-essential services was cancelled, or suspended for a prolonged period of time. But when a woman has to give birth, is pregnant, she is pregnant and she has to give birth. So these are reproductive health, and these has to be taken as essential services. I heard from the director of All India Institute of Medical Sciences, Bhubaneswar, that in case of gynecological service, there was a sharp decline in the number of patients who were there admitted there for any kind of reproductive care or for the purpose of deliveries, where these women have gone. Okay, so this increases their vulnerability. So sexual and reproductive health care must be classified as essential service. Then we have to design economic response and yes, Sneha?
If you just could wrap up in 3-4 minutes.
Yes, sir. 3 minutes. Our response and recovery packages should be seen with a gender lens. And this should include targeted support to feminized sectors and occupations and the organizations which are women owned. We have to talk about strengthening the social protection system to cover all working women. Social protection for women has to be increased. We have to ensure that everybody has access to social protection. And we have to support the hard-hit sectors that employs a larger share of women. We have said that informal sector, the services sector, the sectors which are the hospitality, tourism sector, which employs women. And women-led enterprises and businesses must be supported. They have to be supported. And a gender-responsive procurement and public works program should be put in place so that women entrepreneurs, the women own account producers will get a motivation, or they will get an incentive. It will incentivize them. And allow flexible work arrangements to cope with increased care burden. Schools are closed, children are at home, the women with smaller children, they have to take care of them naturally. Flexible work arrangements, unless I see their left, right, and center, we see women are struggling with small children, how to take care of the small children, take care of the household, and take care of their jobs. That has to have flexi work hours and ensure continuity of basic work services such as housing, water, electricity, to reduce the financial as well as, I would add here, the physical burden on the household, and harness digital solutions to build inclusive crisis response. And these are medium to, I will skip these. Fiscal supports, I'll talk about women's access to decent work, including in non-conventional sectors. And most important, we have to continue to invest in girls' education. Historic underinvestment in social protection and care systems needs to be done. And you have to, what is important, you have to analyze budgets and recovery measures with a gender perspective. That is, we are talking to get a emphasis is to be put on gender budgeting, and encourage multilateralism and a coordinated approach. And to wrap up, I would say that many people say that, is it the right time to talk about gender? Since we are fighting a pandemic, we are fighting a healthcare crisis, people are dying, people are, the infections are at a very high level. Is it the right time to talk about the gender? The answer is a clear cut yes. This is the time to talk about gender. The social structure is not ideal. We have to agree that the social structure is, may not be ideal, but there are positive changes happening all around. And we have to see the glass as being half full, not as half empty. And we have to, this is the time that we have to reconstruct a more just and a more equal world to hand over to our next generation than what we inherited. So this is the time that we have to reconstruct. This is the time that we have to reshape, give it a shape, so that our future generation does not have to fight for it. And we hand over to our gen next a better world than what we inherited from the our previous generation. Thank you so much. I would close here.
Thank you so much, Mitali. It was wonderful. In fact, the right presentation to set the tone of this Yovina. And it is very, you know, like for me, I never thought of, you know, like the matrimonial site has actually a surge in the, you know, registration. So this is something news to me. And I now think why you haven't thought from that point of view. So thank you so much for enlightening on that. And I think the most important thing which you have talked about is the vulnerability. That basically the risk depending on the extent of assets a person is actually having. And we all know how much assets women shares in our society. So that is another reason why it actually impacts very adversely on women. Thank you so much for your wonderful deliberation. And
thank you.
Stay with us.
Yes,
there
I'm there.
Be, you know, questions
yes,
for you.
Yes.
Can I now request Professor Navanita Rath? And in fact, Professor Navanita is going to speak about the crimes against women, and we all know that the domestic violence had got increased multifold during this lockdown system, precisely because the perpetrators have been already there in our homes, and the women being there at the home, they are not able to come out from that home where the perpetrators are there because of the lockdown system. I mean, there is lockdown outside, and there is violence and there is crime going on inside home. It is very difficult to manage and sustain those kind of situation. But even with all this adverse situation, women always look for alternative solutions. Navanita, before I go to you quickly, if you just could, you know, like stop sharing this screen. I thought I'll just, you know, take all of you through the film that Nandita has made. Let's hear. I think that would be something to actually look at. I'm sure many of you must have actually seen it, but I think I can show all of you that film. Is it okay with you, Navanita?
Yes. Can I just make the projection from this side, or you will do it?
No, you can do that. It's not a problem at all.
Is it visible now? Is it
yes,
visible?
It is visible. Navanita, go ahead with your presentation. I think after you present, then I can show that film.
Okay. Yes, and my dear co-panelists, dear participants, and who have joined this digital platform. It is really a privilege on my part to participate in this panel discussion, and it was with a very short span of time when Sneha told me yesterday around at about 1:30 to join this panel. Even if I do not have much idea, I decided I should join because I will get to know many things from this panel. So with this, I will start because she has given me a topic to talk about violence against women in Odisha during COVID-19 and how to address it. My presentation will be not exactly on violence against women in Odisha. It is a very micro presentation because it is a macro thing. Then from violence, I have taken up domestic violence. And again, from domestic violence, I have again gone for talking about intimate partner violence. Because it is my presentation will be based on a micro study which we had done during the pandemic. And I will be telling, and let us start with how COVID-19 is a great challenge. As my previous speaker, my friend Mithali told, perhaps after the two world wars, the Great Depression and the Great Depression, COVID-19 is the greatest disaster the human civilization is encountering right now. This is perhaps the first global biodisaster because biodisasters have taken place, but they were mainly localized within certain geopolitical boundaries. But this is the first time the global it has taken the form of a global disaster and the disaster that is fought by the entire globe. And the World Health Organization declared COVID-19 outbreak as a global emergency on 30th January 2020. This disaster has no doubt created a terror and a tremor. And women have been disproportionately affected by this pandemic. And we are telling it is a pandemic within a pandemic. And if we come to the why we will be focusing more on violence, because we are now talking when women are into this, we are talking about the situation of women, we are talking about their livelihood, and associated with livelihood is the violence against women. And if we go to the global and the national records, we find that the UN Women's Unit and the UNICEF data talks about 1.5 crore women across the world face domestic violence in the 3 months of lockdown. Only it is from April, May, June, or from March to May, they have suffered. Such a large number of people have suffered from domestic violence. And now if we just calculate it with 9 months, it will be, we have to take 3 times of it. And the National Legal Service Authority of India, that is NALSA, noted in India, Uttarakhand, Haryana, and Delhi to be the leading states in terms of violence against women. And Odisha, this is only the rape cases and domestic violence cases. It has not been properly recorded so far as my knowledge goes, because till yesterday, I was trying to find out what is the number, exact number. So maybe there are some pitfalls from the reporting side and there are some lacunae from the recording side. And domestic violence cases, but every one of us will agree that they are on an escalating stage. And India recorded the filing of the highest number of domestic violence cases during the first 4 phases of lockdown. And the National Commission for Women, that is NCW, witnessed that within 3 months, March to May, there were 1,477 cases registered in comparison to the entire year 2019 only registered 607 cases. So now we find that the cases of domestic violence are on rise. And as I wanted to tell you that during this period, we had taken 60 cases and it was a qualitative study where we took women from 3 different classes to know whether the first thing is pandemic is gendered or not. And the second thing we wanted to see the intersectionality during so far as domestic violence is concerned. So far as pandemic, the gender, whether pandemic is gender, pandemic is not gendered in character. Pandemic doesn't discriminate. It is our sociocultural practices that have actually created this discrimination for which the violence on women has went on increasing. And if we look at the intersectionality, we will find normally we say that the higher the class, the less will be the violence, and the lower the class, the higher will be the violence. But domestic violence during this pandemic has cut across caste, community, culture, countries, everything. Everywhere there has been instances of domestic violence. And just I have taken a model from Walker, who said in 1983 that a domestic violence occurs in three different phases. The first is the tension building phase, where the initial rift takes place. And as I have told you that my study was basically on the intimate partner violence, and we found that the tension building phase normally takes a very long time. Then comes the explosion phase, where we find there is direct attack, assault, and all these things. And the honeymooning phase is the least time. It may sometimes come and it may not sometimes come. And in the Walker model, if we put and the 60 cases we had taken, we found many of them who were in the tension building phase, they have got promoted to the explosion phase. And explosion phase actually dominated as a form of intimate partner violence during the period of the pandemic, because there was more attack and the tension building phase had it's actually ended very quickly. So pandemic has no doubt surged the depth of domestic violence during this period, and the honeymoon, none of the people have faced this, have encountered this honeymooning phase. And there are two types of behavioral explosion. Tension building stage behavioral explosion are the simple disagreement, common issues. It was in the month of March and April. But around May, June, July, August, the behavioral expressions were just the right side ones, because it was that the people were getting more and more frustrated. When the frustration rates were increasing, the behavioral expressions of the explosion phase were getting manifested. They were surfacing in a large manner. So thus we can see that how the two different, the behavioral expressions and that were associated with domestic violence started changing. And in the initial phase, it started with the tension building phase, but later on, now we are in the explosion stage of this domestic violence. And if we see the types of violence, normally we talk about the physical violence, but more than physical violence, during those periods, the verbal violence was there, emotional violence was there, financial violence was there, reproductive and sexual violences started dominating the domestic violences in many of the households which were encountering domestic violence. And verbal violence was coming in the form of humiliation, ridicule, screaming, shouting, and physical violence is very common, and creating fear, threatening, they were coming in the form of emotional violence. And financial violence was very common for many women, at least the lower class women, whose husbands were trying to appropriate the incomes and the possessions they had collected over the time. And reproductive and sexual health, sexual violence was common in the middle class and the lower class, where they were forced to have unprotected sex, forced sex, imposing unwanted pregnancies. So all these were, the gender factor came here, where the patriarchy was expressing itself in a very virulent form in these forms of violence. So if we see the typical triggering factors of violence against women, there are certain factors from the male side, and the women themselves had some shortfalls for which domestic violence was taking place. If we see from the male side, as such patriarchy started getting accentuated due to the frustrations that came out of the job loss, income loss, power loss, home confinement, affected habits, and migration reversal. For example, I will tell you, there are certain girls who whose husbands were in a very good position, in a position of power, and when they were asked to sit at home and to do work from home, they could not exercise their power in their workplace, which was shifted to the house, and where the women became victimized. Similarly, the migration reversal, if you see the slum women, due to the migration reversal, when their husbands came back, they had no income and they had suffered a lot in their during their reversal process, and they started just expressing their frustrations by taking the recourse to domestic violence against their wives. And similarly, in some families, there were role reversal, which the male had to accept, but mentally they were not adjusting, because when they were staying at home, they had to do some household chores. Because before me, Mithali Madam was telling that the care economy is taken as the dominant economy, where the women play a significant role. And when this reversal was taking place, that it was also affecting the psyche of many men, which was expressing itself in the form of domestic violence. And the public-private dichotomy was actually taking a change shape. Because in the lower households also, if you find the women who were engaged as domestic workers, after 2 months, they started going. But the men, they didn't get any work. And this changed the public-private, the breadwinning man, and the homemaker woman concept started taking a reverse trend, and that also affected many men's psyche, and that resulted in domestic violence. Similarly, there was a sudden halt in the social security services, like the Anganwadi centers, health services, pensions, closure of family counseling centers, which gave a precedence to the men, and the women were at the mercy of the men, and the men took them as the burden, and this also resulted in violence. And coming to the women's side, we find increased burdens of care work from home, and work from home, care work, and double burden within a single space. All this and multitasking also made them irritated, and sometimes they were also jumping into quarrel, and from quarrel it was turning into violence. And there were job loss, income loss, in loss of self-sufficiency, dependency was rising, and all these were also from the women's side, which was also irritating the men, and that was also irritating the women, and there was conflict from conflict, that it was taking the shape of violence. And the lack of ability, women started having a lack of ability to adjust to the situation of reduced standard of living, changing lifestyle, that also brought rift, and that increased domestic violence in many families, particularly intimate partners' violence. And if we see the impact factor, it has impacted the health, the human rights of women, quality of life and well-being, their quality of life and well-being, their security and status in many, many households. And this has led to the insecurities. And as Madam Mithali was telling, we are on the 25th year of Beijing platform of action. We have rolled back 50 years back. And if you see the issues in the post-COVID, they are still out of sight. We do not know what is coming. They are out of reach. We do not know whether we can handle them or not. They are out of loop. And the government and the agencies may not be having money to just manage them, and out of scope of the government. So we all have to join our hands to combat the domestic violence. And the solution is that domestic violence need not be treated as a private affair. It should be taken of public significance. So reporting and recording, we should be very, very liberal in reporting and recording. And emergency service, it should be taken as an emergency service, and they should be always responded to by the organizations and the agencies. And integrated approach of multiple departments is also needed, because police, housing, health service, safety stay homes need to be combined together to fight against it. And social workers, civil society activism is needed to just put an end to this domestic violence. And public-private partnership, villages and rural areas, in the urban slums, in the urban areas, volunteerism is also required from the side of the women, from the side of the youth clubs, from the elderly societies, so they can do good counseling. Doorstep counseling is there. Safety planning we have to do, and we have to strengthen domestic abuse support services, and the perpetrator sensitization program is a must. And training in technology should be done, so that the helplines that have been created, the apps can be created, better apps where we can provide better security to the women. With this, I wrap up. Thank you.
Thank you, Navanita, for dwelling time. And thank you so much for focusing on so much on our patriarchal system in our society, and the kind of life that the women were actually living earlier. The violence was just not because of the pandemic, but it has gone up because of the pandemic, definitely. And that is the reason why we need to build back a better society for the women in our society and the children in our society. And women have been actually, quite sufferer. But as we all know, and as we all have seen, how we have actually risen to the occasion. I just would like to refer one or two lines from Maya Angelou. "You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I will rise." So that's the spirit of women, and I'm pretty sure with this pandemic, with this kind of disaster, women are going to rise. But yes, we need to set the tones. We need to have, as Professor Mitali was talking about, we have to put the systems in place. And that is the reason why we have Pragya with us, Pragya Paramita Bastias, who is also the coordinator of the helpline for the women. And there are a number of cases that they have also, kind of handled. And I think, Navanita, you're talking about recording of cases. There is no systemic recording of cases. Probably we need to put all those data together. I think in the morning also we were discussing about the problems of not having data, actually a comprehensive data at one place. So these are the area where we need academicians like you and Mitali, who can actually work more on that, and then to keep the data in place and the systems in place to capture all those data. And I would like to, with this, go over to Pragya. Pragya, business bhavare ame jodi dekhiba ei je pandemic samare mahila manko upar hinsa bahut bhavare badhithila, and your helpline has been actually open. Before the pandemic also you were running this helpline. Our pandemic pore bhi apanankar helpline challenge. So you can what was the comparative, the critical analysis between before pandemic and during pandemic, so that picture as they paribo how the agents and services is quite necessary. As Professor Chinara has said in the beginning, that the social services system had to be declared actually essential services. Jyoti Panki won't put a problem in it because of the prolonged, closing down of the social services system. Problems like domestic violence and other kind of violence that was happening on women was not actually been able to address. So with this, Pragya, over to you.
Thank you, Shyamapa. समस्त पैनलिस्ट मन को मो नमस्कार एवं आज मो सहित थिबा समस्त अंश ग्रहण कारी को मो पुन थरे शुभेच्छा जणौछि एवं धन्यवाद दउछि जे वर्तमान हो आपन बडी सुजोग दैछन हमकु एही कंक्लेव रे गोटे कंक्रीट गोटे होछि न्यूमेरिक रिपोर्ट्स को शेयर करबा पई कि समस्त जे जानि छथि 181 वुमेन हेल्पलाइन विषय रे मते लागो छि हम सहित जो माने सब अछथि तथापि मु ता पूर्व प्रस्तुति रखुछि मु कोन से स्लाइड्स ता शेयर करबि न बा सेमेन करबि
ठीक
तो समस्त जानते 181 वोमेन हेल्पलाइन आम निर्भया जो जो है दिल्ली में से घटना पर 2017 मसीह महिला मान को इमीडिएट एंड इमरजेंसी हेल्पिंग सर्विस जोगे देवाई स्टार्ट है मार्च 8 तारीख में कार्यक्रम संपर्क में कहूँ विशेष भाव जिते पेंडामिक महामारी सहित जो कोविड 19 महामारी सहित जो वायलेंस अगेंस्ट वुमेन डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस को आम अधिक गुरुत्व दौचे से देखुचे 181 वुमेन हेल्पलाइन सहित जिते सब इमरजेंसी हेल्पलाइन मान सर्विसेस कार्य बहुत अधिक बढ़ी जाइए तो से समय गोटे आलोचना मानते गोटे कंपेरेटिव एनालिसिस प्रेजेंटेशन को जाऊँ तो आमर जितने मैंने जानते 181 वुमेन हेल्पलाइन हूँ गोटे टेलीफोनिक इमरजेंसी सर्विसेस जिते बड़े मार्च 24 तारीख में संपूर्ण शटडाउन और लॉकडाउन है समय इमीडिएटली समय दिल्ली हाईकोर्ट रोटे माने आसला पिटीशन जे आपण माने कोनोसी एमर पर्टिकुलर वुमेन हेल्पलाइन किबा वन स्टॉप सेंटर जोटा सखी सेंटर प्रत्येक जिल्ला रे अछि एवं ओडिसा रे मध्ये प्रत्येक जिल्ला रे 30 टी जिल्ला रे सखी सेंटर अछि तो एटा को आमे कोनोसी हालत रे बाको बंद कर परिबा नाही तेन करे एटा जेमते 24 घंटा सर्विसेस जोगोतला सेमते सब सर्विसेस जोगबाको बाध्य होबो तो आम से को जो देख लु जो माने इमरजेंसी सर्विसेस रोचे देवा निहाती दरकार समय महिला मान को गोटे आपत्कालीन सेवार बहुत आवश्यकता अच्छी तो से समय देख लु केमती करू आम फिजिकाली जो सब से जेहेतु आपत बुझे महिला मान समय घर भितर काम अधिका रही जाऊँगी बाहर जिते आम कम कर रिक्स नहीं आसुचु से गोटे डबल साइड चैलेंज प्रत्येक आम जो हेल्पलाइन काम करूँ समस्त व्यवस्था था प्रथम जावा असुविधा थी सहित आसला आम जो बिल्डिंग काम करूँ से 200 अधिक ऑफिस अच्छे प्रत्येक ऑफिस पूरा बंद हो जाता गोटे मात्र ऑफिस मैं टोटल एंटायर बिल्डिंग रे आमे माने प्रत्येक शिफ्ट रे आमे 6-7 जन ही झील पिला ही रही आसिकी काम करथले हम रात दिन काम कर व्यवस्था भितर आम भी एटा गोटे मानते चैलेंज हो जाता केवल जे अन्न मान भी इमरजेंसी काम करते सेवा जोगे आम चैलेंज होता निजी भी गोटे चैलेंज था आसिक ये कम कमी करू से भी गोटे बड़ चैलेंज होदे आम मैंने देख लु जे प्रकृत समय कॉल रेट्स टा बहुत अधिक है जिते देखु कंपेरेटिवली एनालिसिस कर देखु प्रत्येक वर्ष भेत आपने देखिए 2020 रे सब अधिक केसेस रजिस्टर कॉल रेट तो हूँ सम लक्ष्य अच्छी किंतु आम मैंने कॉल रेट्स को आम मैंने देख भाविल उचित मन कल तेनालीराम देखु नंबर ऑफ केसेस रजिस्टर आम 2017 मसीह 18 मसीह 19 मसीह कंपेरेटिवली आम देख लु 2020 मसीह अधिक हूँ केसेस रजिस्टर पर्टिकुलर आम देखु को टाइप केसेस रजिस्टर ना अन्य सब प्रकार जो केसेस 48 टाइप ऑफ केसेस आम देखू से भितर आम देख लु प्रत्येक अन्य सब केस रो जो सस्टेन मान स्टेबिलिटी प्राय सब स्टेबल था जितकी आसे कमाइनर से आसूला किंतु वायलेंस अगेंस्ट वुमेन जो वायलेंस अगेंस्ट वुमेन भितर देख लु डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस केसेस सब हाईएस्ट आसला तो ये गोटे कंपेरेटिव ट्राफिकिंग केसेस नौ सेक्सुअल हरेसमेंट केसेस नौ चाइल्ड मैरिज केसेस नौ चाइल्ड पोर्नोग्राफी कथा नौ सहित कन्या भ्रूण हत्या कथा सबकि मिसेकि देखा दूसरी 466 केसेस आम रजिस्टर करूँ जबकि आम कंपेरेटिवली देखु 2019 मसीह 404 केस रजिस्टर करूँ किंतु 2020 मसीह 1702 केस आम रजिस्टर कर माने आपण माने भाभी पारु थिबे 2020 मसीह जेहेतु आरंभ रु प्राय जनवरी फेब्रुवारी छाड़ी देले मार्च पारु ही कोविड आरंभ हो गला तो ड्रास्टिकली आम देखु प्राय 400-500 गुण हूँ केस हूँ अधिका रजिस्टर हो ଏବଂ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ କେବଳ ଭାଉରେ ହଉଛି ଦେଖୁଛୁ ସେତେବେଳେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ, ଯଦି ଆମେ ବି ପୁଣି କ୍ୱାର୍ଟର ୱାଇଜ ତାକୁ ଆନାଲିସିସ୍ କରୁଛୁ କୋଉ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟରରେ ଅଧିକ ଆସୁଛି, 2020 ମସିହାରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଜାନୁଆରୀ ଫେବୃଆରୀ ମାର୍ଚ୍ଚ କଥା ଦେଖୁଛୁ ମାତ୍ର 218ଟା କେସ୍ ଆମେ ରେଜିଷ୍ଟର କରୁଛୁ, କିନ୍ତୁ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟର ଇମିଡିଏଟଲି ଆଫ୍ଟର ଦ ହଉଛି ଲକଡାଉନ ଏଣ୍ଡ ସକଡାଉନ ଆମେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ଯେ 6-7ଟା କେସ୍ ଆମେ ରେଜିଷ୍ଟର କରୁଛୁ, ଏବଂ ମ୍ୟାକ୍ସିମମ୍ ହଉଛି ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଓମେନ୍ କେସେସ୍ ରହୁଛି ଆସୁଛି, ଆମର ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ମଧ୍ୟ ଆମର ସେଥିରେ ସବୁଠାରୁ ଅଧିକ, ଯେମିତି 6-7 କେସ୍ କହୁଛୁ ସେ ଭିତରେ ମ୍ୟାକ୍ସିମମ୍ ଟୁ ମ୍ୟାକ୍ସିମମ୍ ମୁଁ ମଧ୍ୟ ନେକ୍ସଟ ଫ୍ରାଇଡେ ଆମେ ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ର ବି ଗୋଟେ ଆପଣମାନଙ୍କ ଆଗରେ ରଖିଛି। ତ ତା ସହିତ ଥାର୍ଡ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟର ଦେଖୁଛୁ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆସ୍ତେ ଆସ୍ତେ ଚାରିଆଡ଼େ ଫିଟୁଛି ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆସୁଛି ସେଟା 483ଟା କେସ୍ ଆସୁଛି ଏବଂ 394 କେସେସ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ ଫୋର୍ଥ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟର, ଯୋଉଟାକି ଗତକାଲି ପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ ଆମେ ମାନେ ଏଇ ରିପୋର୍ଟକୁ ନେଇଛୁ। ଏବଂ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ରେ ଆମେ କଥା ଦେଖୁଛୁ ସେଟା ମଧ୍ୟ ୟୁଆର ୱାଇଜ କଥା ଦେଖୁଛୁ, ସେଇ 1700 ଯୋଉଟା ଆମର 1702 କେସ୍ ଭିତରୁ ଆମେ 1439ଟା କେବଳ ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ଆସିଛି, 2020 ମସିହାରେ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଟୋଟାଲ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଓମେନ୍ କେସେସ୍ ଦେଖିବା କେବଳ 1439ଟା ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ଆମେ ରେଜିଷ୍ଟର କରୁଛୁ, ଏବଂ ଯୋଉଟାକି ଆମେ ମାନେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ଯେ କୋଉ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟରରେ କେତେଟା କରିଛୁ ସେଟା ବି ସେଇଭଳିଆ ମାର୍ଚ୍ଚ ଏପ୍ରିଲ ମେ ଜାନୁଆରୀ ଫେବୃଆରୀ ମାର୍ଚ୍ଚ ଯୋଉ ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟରରେ ଆମେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ଯେ କମ୍ପାରେଟିଭଲି କମ୍ ଆମେ ମାନେ କେସ୍ ରେଜିଷ୍ଟର କରୁଛୁ, କିନ୍ତୁ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟର ଥାର୍ଡ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟର ଏବଂ ଫୋର୍ଥ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟରରେ ଆମେ ମାନେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ଯେ ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ମାନଙ୍କର ହଉଛି ଅଧିକା କେସେସ୍ ରେଜିଷ୍ଟର କରୁଛୁ। ଏବଂ ଆକୁ ବି ଯଦି ଆମେ ଆଉ ଟିକେ ଆନାଲିଟିକାଲି ଆମେ ଦେଖିବା ଯେ ଆମେ ମାନେ ହଉଛି ଏକ୍ସପିରିଏନ୍ସ ରୁ ଦେଖିଲୁ ବା ତା ସହିତ ଆମ ପାଖରେ ତଥ୍ୟ ଭିତ୍ତିକ ବି ଆମେ କହୁଛୁ ଯେ ଏଇ ସମୟରେ ବିଶେଷ ଭାବରେ ଆମେ ଯେତେ ସବୁ ଆଗରୁ ଟିକେଟ ସବୁ ବା କେସେସ୍ ରେଜିଷ୍ଟର କରୁଥିଲୁ ପ୍ରାୟ ଦେଖୁଥିଲୁ ଇକୋନୋମିକାଲି ଆମର ଯେତେବେଳେ କେସେସ୍ ଦେଖୁ ଯେ ସେମାନେ ହଉଛି ପ୍ରାୟତଃ ନିମ୍ନ ମଧ୍ୟବିତ୍ତ ଶ୍ରେଣୀର ମହିଳାମାନେ ହଉଛି ବେଶୀ ଆମକୁ ଫୋନ କରିକିନା କଥାବାର୍ତ୍ତା କରନ୍ତି, କିନ୍ତୁ ପ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡେମିକ ସମୟରେ ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲୁ ମଧ୍ୟବିତ୍ତ ଏବଂ ଉଚ୍ଚ ଇଭେନ୍ ହାୟର କ୍ଲାସେସ୍ ରହୁଛି ଯୋଉ ସବୁ ମାନେ ମହିଳାମାନେ ମଧ୍ୟ ଅଛନ୍ତି ସେମାନେ ମଧ୍ୟ ଆମକୁ ଫୋନ କରୁଛନ୍ତି ଏବଂ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଆମେ କଣ କରିବୁ ଏଇ ସମୟରେ, ତାଙ୍କ ଘରେ ଭିତରେ ତାଙ୍କର ଏତେ ଡିଷ୍ଟର୍ବାନ୍ସ ହଉଛି ଏବଂ ମ୍ୟାକ୍ସିମମ୍ କେସେସ୍ ଫିଜିକାଲ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ, ଯଦି ଆମେ ଡିଭିର ବି ଆମେ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଆଉ ଟିକେ ଭିତରକୁ ଯିବା ଯେ ମ୍ୟାକ୍ସିମମ୍ ଆଗରୁ ଯୋଉ ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ଆମେ କହୁଥିଲୁ ଭର୍ବାଲ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ ହଉଥିଲା ମାନେ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ ହଉଥିଲା କିମ୍ବା ଇକୋନୋମିକ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ ଅଧିକା ହଉଥିଲା କିମ୍ବା ମେଣ୍ଟାଲି ସେମାନେ ହଉଛି ହାରେଷ୍ଟ କରୁଥିଲେ, କିନ୍ତୁ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ରେ ଆମେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ପ୍ରତ୍ୟେକଟି ଡିଭି କେସ୍ ଫିଜିକାଲ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ ସହିତ ଲିଙ୍କ ଅଛି, ତା ଅର୍ଥ ମାରପିଟ ହେବାଟା ହଉଛି ଗୋଟେ କମନ୍ ଥିଲା ଏବଂ ଏଇଟା ମଧ୍ୟ ମଧ୍ୟବିତ୍ତ ଶ୍ରେଣୀର ମହିଳାମାନଙ୍କ ମଧ୍ୟରେ ବହୁତ ଅଧିକ ଆସିଥିଲା, ଆଉ ସମସ୍ତେ କହୁଥିଲେ ଯେହେତୁ ମଧ୍ୟବିତ୍ତ ଶ୍ରେଣୀର ଏବଂ ନିମ୍ନ ମଧ୍ୟବିତ୍ତ ଶ୍ରେଣୀର ଯେହେତୁ ଆମକୁ ଦେଖିଲୁ ଯେହେତୁ ଅଫିସେସ୍ ବନ୍ଦ ଅଛି ଆମେ ମାନେ ଭାବୁଥିଲୁ ଆଗରୁ ଗୋଟେ ଆମେ ମାନେ ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ଏମିତି ଗୋଟେ କଥା କରେ ଧାରଣା ଥାଏ ଯେ ନିମ୍ନ ମଧ୍ୟବିତ୍ତ ବା ଏକଦମ ଲୋୟର କାଷ୍ଟ ହଉଛି ସେମାନଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ବହୁତ ମାନେ ବହୁତ ଝଗଡା ଝାଟି ହୁଅନ୍ତି ବା ତାଙ୍କ ସ୍ୱାମୀ ମାନେ ତାଙ୍କୁ ବହୁତ ବାଡାବାଡି କରନ୍ତି, କିନ୍ତୁ ଏଇ ମହାମାରୀ ସମୟରେ ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲୁ ମଧ୍ୟବିତ୍ତ ଶ୍ରେଣୀର ପୁରୁଷଙ୍କୁ ମାନେ ମହିଳାମାନଙ୍କୁ ଅଧିକ ବାଡାବାଡି କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ଯୋଉଟାକି ଫିଜିକାଲ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସେସ୍ ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲୁ ସବୁଠାରୁ ଅଧିକ ଆସିଛି, ଡିଭିର ଯୋଉ ଆମେ କାଟେଗୋରି କଲି ପୁଣି ଆନାଲିସିସ୍ ରେ ଫିଜିକାଲ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ ହିଁ ଆମେ ସବୁଠାରୁ ଅଧିକା ଆସିଛି। ଏବଂ ଏଇ ସମୟରେ ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ କଥା ବି ଆମେ ମାନେ କଥା ହେଇପାରିବା ଯୋଉଟାକି ଆମେ ମାନେ ଦେଖିଛୁ ପ୍ରତ୍ୟେକ ବର୍ଷ ଅପେକ୍ଷା ଏଇ ବର୍ଷ ଆମେ ଦେଖିଛୁ ସାଇବର କ୍ରାଇମ କେସେସ୍ ମଧ୍ୟ ଅଧିକ ହେଇଛି, ସବୁଠାରୁ ହାଏଷ୍ଟ 74 କେସେସ୍, ଯେତେବେଳେ 2019 ମସିହାରେ ଆମର ସାଇବର କ୍ରାଇମ ରହୁଛି 37 କେସେସ୍ ଆସୁଥିଲା, ଏକ୍ସାକ୍ଟଲି ହଉଛି ତାର ଫିଗରଟାକୁ ଓଲଟି ଯାଇଛି ଆମର 2020 ମସିହାରେ ସେଟା ଆମର ହେଇଛି 74 କେସେସ୍, ଏବଂ ସାଇବର କ୍ରାଇମ କେସେସ୍ ମଧ୍ୟ ହଉଛି ଆମେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟର ଥାର୍ଡ କ୍ୱାର୍ଟର ହିଁ ସବୁଠାରୁ ଅଧିକ ଆସିଛି, ଅର୍ଥାତ ଏପ୍ରିଲ ମେ ଜୁନ ଜୁଲାଇ ଅଗଷ୍ଟ ସେପ୍ଟେମ୍ବର ଏଇ ସମୟ ଭିତରେ ସବୁଠାରୁ ଅଧିକା ସାଇବର କ୍ରାଇମ କେସେସ୍ ଆସିଛି, କେବଳ ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ମହିଳାମାନଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ଆସିନି ଯୋଉଟାକି ବହୁତ ଅଧିକ ହେଇଛି ଏବଂ ବହୁତ ଅଧିକ ଗୁଣରେ ଆମେ ମାନେ ଦେଖିଲୁ ବଢିଯାଇଛି ସେଟା ହେଲା ସାଇବର କ୍ରାଇମ କେସେସ। ଏଇ ସମୟରେ ଆମେ ମାନେ ବି ଯେତେବେଳେ ହଉଛି ଡବ୍ଲ୍ୟୁସିଟେଡ୍ ଚିନ୍ତା କଲା ଯେହେତୁ ସେତେବେଳେ ଇମିଡିଏଟଲି ଆମକୁ ହଉଛି ସାଙ୍ଗେ ସାଙ୍ଗେ ରେସ୍ପଣ୍ଡ କରିବାକୁ ପଡିଲା ଯେ ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ଅଧିକ ଆସୁଛି, ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଜଣେଇଲୁ ସାଙ୍ଗେ ସାଙ୍ଗେ ଆମେ ଲାଗିଲା 181 ଓମେନ୍ ହେଲ୍ପଲାଇନ୍ ସହିତ, ଯେହେତୁ ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲୁ ଯେ ମଧ୍ୟବିତ୍ତ ଶ୍ରେଣୀର ମହିଳାମାନଙ୍କ ଉପରେ ଅଧିକରୁ ଅଧିକ ଆସୁଛି ଆମର ଡିଭି କେସେସ୍ ଆସୁଛି ଏବଂ ସେମାନେ ଚାହିଁଲେ ଯେ ଆମକୁ ବାରମ୍ବାର ଫୋନ କରିକିନା କହିଲେ ଯେ ଆପଣ ମାନେ ଆମକୁ କିଛି ଗୋଟେ ଡିଜିଟାଲ ପ୍ଲାଟଫର୍ମ ଦିଅନ୍ତୁ ଯୋଉଠିକି ଆମେ ପିକ୍ଚର ସେୟାର କରିବୁ ଆପଣଙ୍କ ସହିତ ଏବଂ ଆମ ସହିତ ଯୋଉ ସବୁ ଘଟଣା ଘଟୁଛି ଯୋଉ ସାଇବର କ୍ରାଇମ ଘଟୁଛି ଆମେ ଆପଣମାନଙ୍କ ସହିତ ଆମର ସବୁ ଯଦି ମ୍ୟାକ୍ସିମମ୍ ଦେଖାଗଲା ଫେସବୁକରେ ହଉଛି ଝିଅମାନଙ୍କୁ ସବୁ ଫଲୋ ଷ୍ଟକିଂ ଯୋଉଟା ଆମର ବହୁତ ଅଧିକ ଆସୁଛି ଏବଂ ପର୍ନ ପିକ୍ଚର ଗୁଡାକ ତାଙ୍କର ସେମାନେ ସେଠି ସେମାନେ ଲିକ୍ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ତ ସେଗୁଡାକୁ ଆମକୁ ଯେହେତୁ ବହୁତ କଲ୍ ଆସିଲେ ଏବଂ ଆମେ ଡିପାର୍ଟମେଣ୍ଟ ହଉଛି ଡାଇରେକ୍ଟର ଏବଂ ସେକ୍ରେଟେରୀ ଆମ ଡିସାଇଡ କଲେ ଯେ ନିହାତି ଆମକୁ ଗୋଟେ ଡୋମେଷ୍ଟିକ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ ରହୁଛି ଗୋଟେ ହେଲ୍ପଲାଇନ ନମ୍ବର ସହିତ ଗୋଟେ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ସଆପ ନମ୍ବରଟେ ଦେବା ଯୋଉଟାକି ଆମେ ଭିଡିଓ ବି ମଧ୍ୟ କଲେକ୍ଟ କରିପାରିବା ଏବଂ ସେମାନେ ଯୋଉ ମହିଳାମାନେ ବି ଚାହୁଁଛନ୍ତି ମେସେଜ ମାଧ୍ୟମରେ ବି ଆମମାନଙ୍କୁ किछे हमको जणे परिबे तो इमीडिएटली आफ्टर जे माने पेंडेमिक जे 2 अप्रैल 17 तारिख दिन आमे माने जे गोटे व्हाट्सएप नंबर हो जे जार गुलु एवं प्रत्येक मीडिया जते सब हमर लोकल ओडिसा रो मीडिया छथि सबतरे आमे स्क्रोलिंग करबा द्वारा आश्चर्यजनक भाबे लागिला आमे जते स्क्रोलिंग स्टार्ट हला राति 9टा रे एवं 12टा भितरे आमे देखलु 700 टा कॉल आसीछि माने जति कि तो मेसेज आसीछि कॉल आसी व्हाट्सएप रे कॉल आसीछि एवं फोन प्रत्येक छवि माड़ खाइबार छवि तो यहाँ गोटे गोटे बहुत मानते आश्चर्य लगे से समय जिते सब आसीला 250 केस फॉलोअप कर समय बहुत कष्ट आसीला जोटा कि आम डी केसेस नौ आम मैंने खाली काउनसलिंग सर्विसेस जोगे बहुत समर्थ हो पार्थु अन्य कि प्रोटेक्शन ऑफिसर सहित लिंक करवा प्रोटेक्शन ऑफिसर हो इमीडिएटली स्टेप्स नबा ए सब कथा हमको आसुतला किंतु पुलिस माने जेतु अन्य सब काम रे बहुत एंगेज थिले जदे हमको इमीडिएटली हो जे हमको हेल्प करथले रेस्क्यू काम रे हमको बहुत हेल्प करथले एवं पुलिस मते तांको भी गोटे हो सर्कुलर मते जाइथला जे से माने हो ए सब क्षेत्र रे इमीडिएट रिस्पोंड करबे तनो रेस्क्यू केसेस गुडा को हम सक्सेसफुल हैंडल करथलु किछि किछि जगह जो महिला माने कोठी रह जाइथले त सेहि सब क्षेत्र रे हम देखथलु जे हो सेमको रेस्क्यू कर किंतु महिला अति अतिष्ठ हो गला मत बाड़ी बहुत बाड़ मार्ग मो बर्तमान असुरक्षित जो इमीडिएटली पुलिस मत मो पाक न पहुंच आम मैंने बर्तमान मरीजी कि आइदर सुसाइड करी ना मत मारिदेवे से सब क्षेत्र में देखा पुलिस इमीडिएटली जाके पहुंची भी आम गोटे बड़ हूँ मानते जो हासिल है एटलिस्ट हूँ पुलिस ये समय बहुत कोऑपरेट कर गोटे कथा है वर्तमान रनिंग नुआ केसेस मन को हमें हैंडल कर किंतु पुराना जो गुड़ा केसेस गुड़ा का थिला देखि जे प्रोटेक्शन ऑफिसर जेहेतु सेत बेले सब प्राय को जो गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसेस बंद थिला तो ये जो डीवी केसेस गुड़ा को मैक्सिमम पेंडिंग है कि रहिला एवं वर्तमान सुधा भी अनेक गुड़े केसेस पेंडिंग है छी गोटी आ गोटी बहुत भलो जिंस से भीतरै थिला डीएलएसएस जो डिस्ट्रिक्ट लीगल सर्विस अथॉरिटी से माने कौन करते ना प्रत्येक हूँ मानते सखी सेंटर को एवं 181 सहित से माने तांकर निजर गोटे काउंसलिंग हेल्पलाइन नंबर टे सहित सेयार करते तो आम जिला भित्तिक जो जिलार डीबी केस आसे आम से जिला भित्तिक आम कौन करूर डीएलएसएस रो दिज को जिले में दिज अच्छा को जिले दिज रु अधिक अच्छा से नंबर सहित सेयार करू एटलिस्ट से लीगल हेल्प से समय इमीडिएटली पाई कौन करेंगे कौन कर न करेंगे से विषय से सहित परामर्श नहीं पारे तो यहाँ थी जो आम डीवी केसेस रिलेटेड किंतु आम भी जो देखुचे केवल जे महिला घर हिंसार शिकार है कि अन्य प्रकार हिंसार शिकार है जो देखा जाए इनफॉरमेशन रिलेटेड टू गवर्नमेंट स्कीम से समय देखा गला महिला राशन बहुत कार्ड समस्त को चावल मिलला गहम मिलला तो अनेक गुड़े से रिलेटेड बहुत गुड़े केसेस रजिस्टर कलु से सेकेंड क्वार्टर ही सब हाइस्ट करूँ आम गोटे ममता स्कीम जिते आम भी कहू ममता स्कीम क्या जेहतु 181 भी ममता स्कीम रोचे ग्रीवेन्स नंबर टा तेणुक ममता स्कीम से समय गोटे कर 6 मास पर्यंत जो आगु 6 मास भितर हूँ जो मैंने रेजिस्टर करते ममता स्कीम अंडर मिलता से 3 मास एक्सटेंड कर तो सेटा एटलिस्ट हूँ लास्ट एंड पर्यंत मैंने ममता स्कीम एनलोड करके पैसा देवाई कैनसल करा गोटे बहुत भल जिनसाइर किसी महिला बेनिफिटेड होते कि सब असुविधा होता जो हटात सब बंद हो गला इंटरस्टेट जो देख लु अन्य राज्य जो महिला मैंने आसिक एपटे रही जाइए तो डेलीवरी केसेस जमी है प्रेगनेंट वुमेन मान जमी असुविधा तो ये स्कीम रिलेटेड से किसी बेनिफिट पारे जोटा कि आम पोर्टेबल भी नाला ममता स्कीम अगर गोटे राज्य में पाथ आम सर्विसेस जोगे दूसरी लिंक कर दूसू आम जो अच्छा डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रोग्राम कोऑर्डिनेटर सहित लिंक करके सर्विसेस जोगे दूसू कि जो कैश ट्रांजेक्शन व्यवस्था था समय कर एटा हला इमर्जेंसी हेल्पलाइन रो आमे मन करो जोटा
थैंक यू सो मच प्रज्ञा भौजी बहुत प्रांजल भाबे बुझि देछंती जे कोहुली भाबरे केसेस सब रजिस्ट्रेशन हेछि हेल्पलाइन रे जदि 2017 मसे आरंभ होइछि लोकमान को पाखरे से मेसेज पहुचिबा जे 181 को अपन फोन करबे आ तार माने पण बेनिफिट लोक माने नै चंती सेटा ला सबटो बडो दिस आ विशेष भाबरे जे लॉकडाउन समय रे जते बेला माने देखि चंती जे डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस करूची नेशनल कमिशन चेयरपर्सन जते बडे नेशनल कमिशन को माने चेयरपर्सन भी कहितिले आ ता परे परे इनफैक्ट बिफोर दैट हमर चीफ मिनिस्टर भी बडे अनाउंस करितिले जे महिला मान को ऊपर बेसी प्रेशर आसुची जे लॉकडाउन समय रे बडी कहि कि ता परे परे किछि किछि कार्यक्रम आरंभ होइतिला we could not get actually shiny man over here IGCA and could I come up with say somewhere she is busy little bit today but jo helpline and then specifically jo whatsapp number jari kari bare takar bahut bhumika rahi line it is wonderful to in the at least ame ethu jani pa je essential service under re yaku open kari ki rakhibara kete avashyakata thila jo ta ame mane actually miss kari chanti aur jo thi pain ki वायलेंस हट एक्चुअली मान महिला मान ऊपर बेसी वायलेंस बढ़ी एंड प्रोबेबली से समय इमीडिएटली रोक जाए पार था बट इट कुड नॉट हैव हैपेंड बट या देयर इज ऑलवेज यू नो लाइक आमे आमर एक्सपीरियंस लर्न करिवा दरकार एंड आल्सो वी नीड टू स्ट्रेटजाइज आवर सेल्फ थैंक यू सो मच प्रज्ञा फॉर द वंडरफुल प्रेजेंटेशन एंड इनफैक्ट बहुत बढ़िया इनसाइट एटा दउची जे महिला मानकर केते आवश्यकता रहिचे एंड आई थिंक आई वाज looking into the question and answer box kete bade question answer asichi one of our friends was quite worried ki purusha loko manko pai ki kono problem hoy ki because they are you know like going out in search of the livelihood and they are you know getting exposed to the problem so how big it is a problem for men yes it is also a problem for men and women but as we all see how it disproportionately impacts women's life so e guda kon chiketa nichha udaharan ta upare जो भी पाए कि there's a need of working with you know like women and also kind of strengthening all these service systems and in place mu professor kundu mu apan ko pakha ko asili before that I would like to go to ghasiram karan ghasiram panda se kaam karuchanti vishesh bhavare balya vivaha upare in our state and in fact bahut comprehensively bare kaam karuchanti khali field and me is also kind of you know like instrumental in putting the policy in place in our state so he has vast experience on that jemti ame dekhile from the very beginning mahila man ko upare aur jhiya man ko upare yaar impact koboli bhavare padchi specifically am janu che je early marriage ra gote reason hochi jodi jhiya man le takar paata pada drop out karanti and in fact in the first presentation itself professor Mitali Chinara has already said ki how girls are going to be very deprived from the education because of this pandemic ame dekhuche education system ro bahut bhavarishya mane drop te jauchanti drop out hochanti aw pandemic gote ahuri gote scope deuchi saman ka ahuri beshi drop out haba pai and ei samaye re ama manku ahuri strategically role play kariba ko chhi so that jo consequence rouchi even child marriage and you know education it is complementing to each other jodi ame jhiya mananka education ko na dekhuche so you know there would be also early marriages so that had to be prevented so to among ko samasta ko gote wala inside daba pai and also to you know like so the kind of problem that has happened specifically during this lockdown period during this pandemic you know thing mu anurodh karibi ghasiram pandan ko so ghasiram over to you please take the witness from here and ghasiram kara sarila pore we will open the session for question and answer and then I'll definitely come to you professor kundu kindly bear with us for during that part of time ghasiram
thank you madam and respected co-panelists and the participants I don't have a presentation I will share whatever I have experienced while working on this issue during this lockdown ghasiram. And am I audible?
Yes, you are. But I was looking for you, and I could not get you, so I thought you have not opened your camera. Yes, you are. Yeah.
Yeah. And for the those who are actually only understanding English, I have my laptop published in downward is in the chat box. Please refer to that, and you can. Have the same what I am going to share now. I will prefer to discuss this in Odia because most of the participant the Odia will be helpful for them. So for those who are actually referring to English, please go through those articles also. And In specific kind of queries, I'll be happy to respond in both in Odia and English. Ajiro jo mo purboru tini jana upasthapika tankar upasthan karichanti tathya ku nekiri samaste kichi na kichi tathya rakhichanti jaha mu bartaman taku hi jodi kiri agaku nebi jemiti madam Mitali Chinara kahila bele kohutile je unpaid work ra katha taku madhya ame balya bibaha sahita jodi kiri dekhi pariba seita bi gote karana push kare balya bibaha ku nekiri Jemiti Amaro Madam Nobanita Madam Rakutile jo behavioral expression Rakata. Say behavioral expression Vitare Madhya Amarjo social norm such traditional norm such among how that has been promoting all the child marriage, the practice of child marriage, Seita Madhya Tabitere Ame Dekhi Pariba. Ebong Pragyajo Postapana Re Rakhile number of domestic violence cases. Muta Babuchi Tavitre Jetable Balebi Bar, Sikar won the Giamone. Among Seymane, E. Goroi Hinsare, Bohut Matrare, Probabito Bonti. Tenukri Tavitru on a Kotana, Queto, Balebi Barovit, Hyper. Ekota, Kohilabere, Mo Covid Committee, Probabito Korichi, Balebi Baku, Sampor Koremojo, Kichito, Totio, Aponka Mankragre, Rokibi, Jetable, June, March Masora, Taste Tarigre Amoro. Bond hella, lockdown hella. Ta porotu, Odisaro, Sobutu Besi, Balle Vibaho, Probono, Tiba Pondorati Gilare Amorjetu, Upostiti Rohichi, Jota Rajoro Haro Amoro, Odisare, Balle Vibaharo, Gio Manoncopaju, Balle Vibahuitar Haro, Equis the Sneak Team, Ebong Tatu, Uporokuju, Gilla Sobuchanti Pondorati Gilla, Ebong Tabitu Pry, Norti Gilla, Juman Jatio Haru Modio, Urdare, Sejilla Manangre, Ame Janitiba. Balya Vibahar Sankhya November Masa Sesha Suddha Auchi 518 Jahaku Ame Bond Kari Parichu Ebong Ta Ame Najani Thiba Bond Kariba Prakriya Ti Jilla Prashasan Exenade Ebong UNICEF Ra Milito Prakriya Bhitare Heichi Ebong Ame Jani Parinathiba Ghatana Hoito Ahuri Adhika Houthai Pare Jehetu Community Level Re Monitoring and Tracking Ra Prakriya Ti Ete Matrare Ei Samaya Bhitare Hei Parinahi तेनु एठु अनुमान करा जाई पारे जे मात्र 15 टी जिल्ला रे आमो सूचना भितर को आसीथिबा मार्च मासरु नोव्हेंबर मासरो संख्या यदि 518 हुए ताले 30 टी जिल्ला रे आमे जानीथिबा एवं न जानीथिबा बाल्य विवाह रो संख्या एटा केवल बंद हेथिबा संख्या मोर कहउची एवं बाल्य विवाह हे जाईथिबा संख्या मध्ये आपण माने एथिरे जोडी पारिबे या सहित आपण यदि देखिबे जे यूएनएफपीए गोटे रिपोर्ट प्रकाश करिसेंती या भितरे 2020 रु 2030 भितरे प्रायतः 13 मिलियन नूतन बाल्य विवाह जोडी हेबो बोली तांकर मत अछि एवं भारत होउची बाल्य विवाह होतबा सबटु अधिक बाल्य विवाह होतबा देश यदि 13 मिलियन ग्लोबली जोडी हेबो ताहेले आमे निश्चित भाबरे आमो भागरे सेतु अधिक हि पडिबो कारण एबे भी आमे आमो भागरे अधिक अछि एवं एहा सत हेइ पारे एथि पई जे जेते बेले इबोला हला अफ्रीका रे ता परवर्तीर जो स्थिति हेछि सेतिरे बाल्य विवाह बढीछि तेणुकरी कोनोसी भी जेतेले डिजास्टर आसे कोनोसी भी विपर्जय आसे से विशेष भाबरे समस्तंकु प्रभावित करूथिले मध्ये विशेष भाबरे महिला एवं शिशु मानंकु प्रभावित करे एवं झियो पिलाटी जे महिला भी एवं शिशु भी से ता प्रभाव रो शिकार अधिक मात्रा रे हेइथाय याकु आउ गोटे तथ्य मध्ये मु जोडीबा पई चाहिबी कलिकता हाई कोर्ट मध्य या उपरे गोटिए अलर्मिंग सिचुएशन को नेकिरी तांकर जजमेंट देइचंती एवं सरकार को सेठी निर्देशित करिचंती जे वर्तमान समय रे अधिक बाल्य विवाह उचित एवं ताकु नेकिरी कार्यानुष्ठान ग्रहण करा जाउ तो जो मुख्यतः हमर फोकसटा कोविड समय रे स्वास्थ्य केंद्रित होइगला सेही समय रे अनेक अलगा सामाजिक एवं अर्थनैतिक समस्या को आमे इग्नोर करिगलु ता भितरे ए कथा गुडी को घटी चलिला एवं जून आ जुलाई मास भितरे जदि आपण देखिबे जेमति ए प्रज्ञा हेल्पलाइन रो कथा कहुतिरे से चाइल्ड लाइन रो जो इन्फॉर्मेशन नेशनली अछि जातीय स्तर रे चाइल्ड लाइन रो तथ्य को तर्जमा करिकि चाइल्ड लाइन ही कहिछि जे 2019 तुलना रे 2020 मास रे जून जुलाई मास रे 2020 रो यदि पूर्व वर्ष एवं ए वर्ष रो तुलना करिबा ताहले 17% डिस्ट्रेस कॉल जोटा केवल चाइल्ड मैरिज को नहीं करी ऐसी सरा इंक्रीज करी 17% इंक्रीज करी तो जातीय स्तर रे 17% इनक्रीज करिछि माने तार जदि नंबर रे आपण कन्वर्ट करिवे ताहेले एक बहुत बड़ संख्या निश्चित भाव रे हबो। तो एठू जणा पडुछि जे बाल्य विवाह रो जो घटना गुड़िक विशेष करी ए समय रे अनेक मात्रा रे घटिछि ताकु तुलना करिवा पई गत वर्ष ए वर्ष भितरे आम पाखरे जेतु कंपेरेटिव डाटा नै बढ़िछि बा कमिछि कहिबाटा संख्यिक भाव रे संभव नहि पारिले भी आमे जो परिवेश अच्छी एवं जो स्थिति आम आम आखपाखे देखुचु जो प्रकार सामाजिक और अर्थनैतिक स्थिति अच्छी तार आधार में एक आम कहीपर कहींपर ना जो जो कारण जो बाल्य बहुत बढ़े से सबू कारण भितर जी लोक आगर थे एवं अधिक लोक से भितर को पशिं आप मैडम मिताली चिन्नर उपस्थापना समय जी लक्ष्य करेंगे जो कथा कहुची जो आम 10 वर्ष पछक फेरीगलु आमर दारिद्र्य आहरी बढ़ीगला दारिद्रता भितर को अधिक लोक पशि आसिले आमर भनेरेबिलिटी बा विपद संकुलता मध्य सेई मात्रा रे बढ़ीगला एवं अधिक लोक जेतेबेले विपद संकुल परिवेश भितर को आसंती सेतेबेले आमको जो तार समस्या को सम्मुखीन होबा को पड़े तार बेसी भाग आमर महिला माने एवं शिशु माने भरणा कर एवं एई समय भितरे आमर गोटे थॉट अछि आमर गोटे चिंतन एया अछि जे विवाह टाकु एटा जदियो आमे गोटे समस्या बोली कहुचु किंतु याकु सबु बेले गोटे समाधान रो बाटो बोली लोक धरि नियंती एटा गोटे प्रॉब्लम बट एटाकु गोटे सोल्यूशन आकार अनेक मात्रा रे ट्रीट करा जाय तेनु जहा असुविधा हबो जहा सुविधा हबो से तार गोटे कारण होची झियो को बाहा कर दियो बाहा करि देबा लोक भी ताकु समाधान बोली भाबे बाहा हेउतबा लोकटो भी ताकु समाधान बोली भाबे बाहा करुथबा लोक लॉकडाउन समय रे एथि पई ताकु समाधान बोली भाबिला जे लॉकडाउन बेले जेहेतु 20 लोक बा 50 लोक भितरे बाहागर करिवो सेभली सरकार नियम कले ता पई सेरे गोटे सुजोग तयारी हला जे कम पैसा रे कम लोकंकु डाकिकिर से बाहागरटी करिवो एवं सेथि पई कहिबाकु पडिवो जे मो पाखरे पैसा नाही बोली मो डाकिली नाही कहि परिवो नाही सरकार मना करछि तेनकु डाकिली नाही बोली कहि परिवो तो से कम खर्च करिवार गोटे व्यवस्था भितरे बाहागरटी जेतु अनुष्ठित हो जाए से गोटे समाधान बाट बोली भाविए बाहर लोकटे भी बहुत मध्यम घर को गोटे डोमेस्टिक वर्कर भाया गोटे आणला घर घर को किसी अन्य घर अर्थ आसला यही गोटे सपोर्टिंग हैंड आसला यही अनेक समाधान कथा नहीं चिंता करते सबुठ गोटे बड़ फैक्टर यही समय जहाँ कंट्रब्यूट कर कारण आम प्राय पाखापाखी यही समय भितर 42 केस स्टडी आम संग्रह कर 15 जिलूँ अनुध्यान करशीलन करें गोटे कथा देखी स्कूल बंद हवा गोटे बहुत बड़ कारण कारण स्कूल टा केवल गोटे पाठ पढ़ार जगह नाला पिला स्कूल रे अनेक कथा से आसिक सेयार करती सांग मान सहित सेयार करती शिक्षक शिक्षयित्री मान सेयार करती घर जदि डोमेस्टिक भायोलेंस शिकार हुए घर जदि बाध्यतामूलक विवाह करदे कथा हुए घर जदि अलग कौन झगड़ा जाटी हुए तार जो प्रभाव पड़े आईदर सेयार करती ना हाव भाव शिक्षक मैंने एक कथा को ठौरा या पूर्वर मध्य अनेक उदाहरण अच्छी जोटी शिक्षक मैंने ये समस्या को चिन्हट करी बाल्य विवाह को बंद करु एवं विद्यालय जेहेतु बंद होगा से भाई गोटे प्रक्रिया संपूर्ण भाव में बंद होगा कारण बहुत पिलाखे मोबाइल ना कि असुविधा है फोन कर जनईदेपर तेणुक एत लंबा समय धरिक विद्यालय बंद है बेले जो बाध्यतामूलक भाव में निष्पत्ति थोपी दि जाइए घरे विवाह करने बाध्य से कथा से क्या कही पार नहीं कहार साहय नहीं पार नहीं समस्ते 1098 भितर विषय जाणी न थी पारती अलग हेल्पलाइन विषय जाणि न थी पारती जाणी भी निज पाखे फोन न थी पारे कि स्कूल को आसे मध्यम सेनेक कथा टी जन दिखती तो से प्रक्रिया अनेक मात्रा प्रभावित है एवं जिते बड़े लॉकडाउन प्रक्रिया समय गाँव को अनेक बाहर थी युवक मैंने आसिले से भाई किसी घटना नजर को आसी जो थे गाँव रहा युवती मानक विभिन्न कारण मध्यम प्रभावित करिसंती प्रलोभित करिसंती गोटे इलोपमेंट प्रक्रिया उधुलिया जीवार प्रक्रिया टी जोड़ी से भाई किसी घटना संग्रह कर तो सब प्रक्रिया गुड़िक अनेक मात्रा देखा देखी एवं इनिशियल फेज जिते लॉकडाउन आरंभ है सेतेबेले चाइल्ड वेलफेयर कमिटी हो केवल चाइल्ड लाइन रो व्यवस्था को छाड़ी देले अन्य जो शिशु मानंकु सुरक्षा देबा पई थिबा व्यवस्था सेगुडाक अनेक मात्रा रे प्रभावित होगा रेगुलर हो पारा ना जो मैंने फ्रंटलाइन वर्कर थे अंगनवाड़ी वर्कर्स इत्यादि से मैंने सीधा सड़क स्वास्थ्य काम विशेष भाव में जड़ित है क्वारंटाइन सेन्टर संभालबार समय गला तेणुक जो कम्युनिटी लेवल ट्रेकिंग एंड मॉनिटरिंग से समय विशेष भाव में बाधाप्राप्त है से ही कारण अनेक बाल्य बिवाह घटला आउ घटी बाल्य बिवाह को प्रशासन जानवर सुजोग रहिला ना तो यही सब कारण मोट भाव लॉकडाउन समय बाल्य बिवाह को आग को बढ़ेगी पिला अनेक मात्रा रे प्रभावित करी पूर्व आलोचना होता जे कौन सी कारण से ड्रॉप आउट हो गले शिक्षा व्यवस्था भितर बाहरी गले कैरियर गोटे मात्र ऑप्शन होची विवाह सेटा को ही देखा जाए तेणुक से प्रक्रिया भितर अनेक झील प्रभावित होती अनेक प्रश्न आसूस पुरुष मान प्रभाव पड़ी कि बाल्य बिवाह प्रक्रिया भितर अनेक पुओ माने कम बयस बिवाह करती प्रभाव पड़ी बाल्य बिवाह कर बड़ लोक भी प्रभावित होती किंतु अधिकांश भाव ए प्रभावटा विशेष भाव जो मान क्षति सहवा को पड़े सी होंगे झील पिला माने एठी जो एब्यूजेस रहा हूँ जो भायलेंस रहा हूँ तो कह बाल्य बिवाह ए सब कुछ से शिक्षा अधिकार वंचित हुए विकास बाहरी जाए एवं प्रतिदिन बिवाह ना रे से जौन निर्यातनार शिकार हुए प्रतिदिन घरे बिवाह ना रे से शिशु श्रमिक भाव में निर्यातिता हुए तेणुक घटना गुड़िकमर डेटाबेस भितर को पशिवार आवश्यकता रही जो माने बाल्य बिवाह रे प्रभावित होती से माने भायलेंस रो शिकार होती से माने शिशु श्रमिक बोली आम कही से माने ड्रॉप आउट्स बोलिक आम कही पार यही प्रक्रिया भितर कौन हो पारी तार परवर्ती समय रे जेते बेले संपूर्ण प्रशासन स्वास्थ्य केंद्रिक हो जाते आम को आउ थे प्रशासन को ए विषय सचेतन करवा कष्टकर हो पड़ा ए विषय हटात किना स्वर उत्तोलन करवा जनवा कष्टकर हो पड़ा किंतु जिते बड़े संख्या सब आसवा आरंभ है सेते प्रशासन चिंतित हेले गोटे राज्य स्तरीय कमिटी गठन कर प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट नेतृत्व में से कमिटी तुरंत या उपरे बैठक कले प्रत्येक जिला को ए दिगरे काम आरंभ करने निष्पत्ति ने डिस्ट्रिक्ट टास्कफोर्स गुड़िक बसवा आरंभ है से पर्यटन आमको बहुत कष्ट होता है जिला प्रशासन के विषय अनुरोध करवा कारण से टीएमसी मैनेज करवा जो माइग्रेंट लेबर मैनेज करवा से दिगरे अधिक मात्रा रे व्यस्त रहते कि एमती गोटे मानवाधिकार हनन है भाया घटना घटी चलूला तो परे परे प्रक्रिया गुड़िक टिके टिके सुधुरीबा आरंभ कला एबे जो सिस्टम आमर अच्छी जहाँ शिशु मानकर अधिकार को सुरक्षित करार आवश्यकता बोले अनुभव कर सिस्टम गुड़ाक धीरे धीरे प्रिभेल करवा आरंभ कला किंतु आमको आहरी अनेक काम करार अच्छी गोटे भल कथा ओडिशा सरकार गोटे अद्विक बोली गोटे कार्यक्रम आरंभ कर जो थे राज्य सहरांचल और ग्रामांचल प्रत्येक एडोलेसेंट गर्ल को देहरे एनुमरेशन कर प्रक्रिया आरंभ हो से मसर चारोटी जाक शनिवार से सहित एनगेज करवस्था करालीम प्रक्रिया आरंभ हो यार गोटे परिणाम जे लॉकडाउन समय रे जो स्थिति है केमी डील कर एक आसला निजे जिते बड़े बाल्य बिवाह शिकार हो झील मैंने से माने निजे तार गोटे पर बाहक हेबे निजे बाल्य बिवाह को ना करिवार साहस तांको भितरे आसिबो ताहा हेले जाई बाल्य बिवाह रोकिबा दिगरे आमे सफल हबा से बळी गोटे प्रक्रिया वर्तमान आरंभ होईची एवं अन्यान्य जिला मानकर कोरापुट रे गोटे अपराजिता अभियान आरंभ होईची जोथिरे इलोपमेंट को 18 वर्ष रु तळर इलोपमेंट को नेकि व्यापक अभियान करा जाउची गंजाम रे निर्भया कढ़ी बोली जिला प्रशासन तरफ गोटे अभियान आरंभ हो जो थे एडोलेसेंट मान मिसेक सचेतन कर प्रक्रिया आरंभ होती आहरी दुई तीन टी काम करवा पड़े मुझे प्रस्ताव रखिक मोर वक्तव्य को सारी गोटे हूँ पर आमको सुदृढ़ करने को पड़े फैमिली को स्ट्रेंथन करने को पड़े जो जो प्रकार ड्यूज अच्छी देय देवार अच्छी एम तार रोजगार पलि जा तेणुक अनेक जगह से ऋण सुझार थाए से ऋण गुड़िक वेब आउट हबार आवश्यकता अच्छे ଏବଂ ତାଙ୍କୁ ବିକଳ୍ପ ଜୀବନ ଜୀବିକା ଭିତରେ ଯୋଡ଼ିବା ପାଇଁ ଛୋଟ ଛୋଟ ଆର୍ଥିକ ସହଯୋଗ 4-5 ହଜାର ଟଙ୍କାର ସହଯୋଗ ଦେଲା ପରେ ବି ଲୋକମାନେ ବଢିଆ ବଢିଆ କାର୍ଯ୍ୟକ୍ରମ ହାତକୁ ନେଇଛନ୍ତି, ଉଦାହରଣ ଅଛି। ତ ସେଇଭଳି କିଛି କିଛି କଥା ଆମକୁ ଆରମ୍ଭ କରିବାକୁ ପଡିବ। ପରିବାରକୁ ସୁଦୃଢ଼ କଲେ ଯାଇ ଦାରିଦ୍ର୍ୟ ଦୂରୀକରଣ ହେଇପାରିବ ଏବଂ ଝିଅମାନଙ୍କର ପାଠପଢ଼ାରେ ସେମାନେ ଅଧିକ ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ କରିପାରିବେ। ଘରେ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ପିଲାମାନଙ୍କୁ ନେଇକି ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ କରିବା କମି ଯାଇଛି, ତାଙ୍କର ପାଠପଢ଼ାରେ ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ, ତାଙ୍କର ଖାଇବାରେ ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ, ତାଙ୍କୁ ନେଇକିରି ବାହାରେ ବୁଲେଇବାରେ ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ, ଏ କଥା ଗୁଡ଼ିକ ବହୁତ ମାତ୍ରାରେ କମିଯାଇଛି। ତେଣୁକରି ପରିବାର ସୁଦୃଢ଼ କରିବା ସବୁଠୁ ଗୋଟେ ମୂଳ କଥା। ଦ୍ୱିତୀୟ କଥାଟି ହେଉଛି ଆମର ଯେଉଁ ସିଷ୍ଟମ ଅଛି, ଫ୍ରଣ୍ଟଲାଇନ୍ ୱାର୍କରଠୁ ଆରମ୍ଭ କରିକି ରାଜ୍ୟସ୍ତରୀୟ କମିଟି ପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ, ଏମାନଙ୍କୁ ଆହୁରି ସମ୍ବେଦନଶୀଳ କରିବାକୁ ପଡିବ। ଶିଶୁମାନଙ୍କର କଥାଟି ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ସୁଦ୍ଧା ହୁଏତ କିଛି ଗୁରୁତ୍ୱପୂର୍ଣ୍ଣ ମନେ ହେଉଛି, କିନ୍ତୁ ପ୍ରାଥମିକତା ପାଇନାହିଁ। ଏହା ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ଫରକ ରହୁଛି, ଗୁରୁତ୍ୱପୂର୍ଣ୍ଣ ଧୀରେ ଧୀରେ ଆସୁଛି। ଏବେ ନିରୁଦ୍ଦିଷ୍ଟ ଶିଶୁମାନଙ୍କର କଥା ଆଲୋଚନା ହେଉଛି ରାଜ୍ୟରେ ବ୍ୟାପକ ଭାବରେ, ତ ଗୁରୁତ୍ୱ ଦିଆଯାଉଛି କିଛି ସମୟରେ, କିନ୍ତୁ ଏପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ ପ୍ରାୟୋରିଟି ଭିତରକୁ ଆସିପାରୁନାହିଁ। ତେଣୁକରି ଅନେକ କମିଟି ଅଛି ଜିଲ୍ଲାରେ, ପଞ୍ଚାୟତରେ, ବ୍ଲକରେ, ସେ କମିଟି ଗୁଡ଼ାକ ବସେ ନାହିଁ। ସେ କମିଟି ଗୁଡ଼ାକୁ ଆମକୁ ସକ୍ରିୟ କରିବାକୁ ପଡିବ। ଆଜି ଓଡ଼ିଶା ଶିଶୁ ଅଧିକାର ସୁରକ୍ଷା ଆୟୋଗ ଗୋଟେ ବିଧାୟକମାନଙ୍କୁ ଗୋଟେ ଅପିଲ କରିଛନ୍ତି, ଚିଠି କରିଛନ୍ତି ଯେ କାହିଁକି ଆମେ 3 ମାସରେ ଗୋଟିଏ ଦିନ, କ୍ୱାର୍ଟରଲି ୱାନ୍ ଡେ, କେବଳ ପିଲାଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଦିନ ବୋଲି କହିବା ନାହିଁ, ଏବଂ ସେ ଗୋଟିଏ ଦିନ ବ୍ଲକରେ, ପଞ୍ଚାୟତରେ ଏବଂ ଜିଲ୍ଲାରେ ଜିଲ୍ଲାପାଳଙ୍କ ଯେହେତୁ ଅଧ୍ୟକ୍ଷତାରେ ଅନେକ କମିଟି ଅଛି, ସେ ଗୋଟିଏ ଦିନ ଦିଅନ୍ତୁ। 3 ମାସରେ ଗୋଟେ ଦିନ କ'ଣ ପିଲାଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ସେମାନେ ଦେଇପାରିବେ ନାହିଁ? ଏତେ ଏତେ ବ୍ୟସ୍ତତା, ଯଦି ଏତେ ବ୍ୟସ୍ତତା ତାହେଲେ ଅଲଗା କାହାକୁ ସେ ଦାୟିତ୍ୱଟା ଆମେ ଦେବାକୁ ପଡିବ। ଏବଂ ବିଧାୟକମାନେ ଏ ଦିଗରେ ଭୂମିକା ନିଅନ୍ତୁ, କାରଣ ରାଜନୈତିକ ଇଚ୍ଛାଶକ୍ତି ନ ଆସିବା ଯାଏଁ ପିଲାମାନଙ୍କର ଇସ୍ୟୁ ହେଇକି ରହିବ ନାହିଁ। ତେଣୁ ପିଲାଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଦିନଟିଏ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ସେହି ପ୍ରକ୍ରିୟାଟିକୁ ଆଗକୁ ବଢାଇବା ପାଇଁ ସେଥିରେ ଅପିଲ ଅଛି। ଏବଂ ପିଲାମାନଙ୍କୁ ବିଧାୟକମାନେ ଯେମିତି ନିଜ ନିଜର ବ୍ଲକରେ ଗୋଟେ ଗୋଟେ ନୋମିନି ବାଛନ୍ତି, ପ୍ରତ୍ୟେକ ପଞ୍ଚାୟତରେ ଗୋଟେ ଶିଶୁ ପ୍ରତିନିଧି ଆକାରରେ, ନୋମିନି ଆକାରରେ ବାଛନ୍ତୁ, ଏବଂ ସେମାନଙ୍କୁ ମଧ୍ୟ ଶାସନ ଏବଂ ବିକାଶ ପ୍ରକ୍ରିୟା ଭିତରେ ସାମିଲ କରନ୍ତୁ, ଯାହାଦ୍ୱାରା ଶିଶୁମାନଙ୍କର ସମସ୍ୟା ଆଗକୁ ଆସିବ ଏବଂ ଚାଇଲ୍ଡ ଫ୍ରେଣ୍ଡଲି କନ୍ଷ୍ଟିଚୁଏନ୍ସିର ପରିକଳ୍ପନା ସେଥିରୁ ହେଇପାରିବ। ଏଇଟା ହୁଏତ ଗୋଟେ ୟୁଟୋପିଆନ୍ ଥଟ୍ ଭଳିଆ ହେଇପାରେ, କିନ୍ତୁ ଏହାକୁ ଆମକୁ କହିବାକୁ ପଡିବ ବାରମ୍ବାର, ଏବଂ ସେ ଦିଗରେ ପ୍ରୟାସ କରିବାକୁ ଆମକୁ ପଡିବ। ଏଠି ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ କଥା କହିକିରି ମୋର ବକ୍ତବ୍ୟ ପ୍ରସ୍ତାବରେ ରଖିବି ଯେ ବାଲ୍ୟ ବିବାହ ଗୋଟେ ଏମିତି ପ୍ରକ୍ରିୟା ଯେଉଁଥିରେ ଆମେ ସମସ୍ତେ ତାକୁ ଗୋଟେ ଅନୈତିକ ଏବଂ ଅସାମାଜିକ ତ ଏବେ କହି ହଉ ନାହିଁ, ଇଲିଗାଲ ବେଆଇନ କାମଟିକୁ ଆମେ ସାମାଜିକ ସ୍ୱୀକୃତି ଦେଇଦେଉ, 501 ଦେଇକିରି ଭୋଜି ଖାଇକିରି ଆଶୀର୍ବାଦ ଦେଇକିରି ଆସୁ, କିନ୍ତୁ ପ୍ରକୃତରେ ସେଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ଇଲିଗାଲ ୱାର୍କ ଥାଏ। ତେଣୁ ଏଇ ଯେଉଁ ପ୍ରମୋଟିଂ ପ୍ରୋସେସରେ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ବି ଅଛନ୍ତି, ଟେଣ୍ଟ ବାଲା ହଉ, ସେ ପୁରୋହିତ ହଉ, ସେ ମଧ୍ୟସ୍ଥି ହଉ, ଟେମ୍ପଲ ଟ୍ରଷ୍ଟ ହଉ, ଯେଉଁମାନେ ବି ପ୍ରିଣ୍ଟିଂ ପ୍ରେସ୍ ବି ହଉ, ସେ ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କୁ ଆମକୁ ଗୋଟେ ଏଇ ଅଭିଯାନର ଏଲଇ ଆକାରରେ, ଏଇ ଅଭିଯାନର ସମର୍ଥକ ଆକାରରେ ଆମକୁ ଆଣିବାକୁ ପଡିବ। ଏମିତି କାହାକୁ ଆମେ ଛାଡ଼ିବା ନାହିଁ ଯିଏ ଏଥିରେ ସାମିଲ ନ ହେଇପାରିବ। ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କୁ ଆମକୁ ଏ ଅଭିଯାନ ଭିତରକୁ ଆଣିକିରି ଆଗକୁ ବଢ଼ିଲେ ଏମିତି ହେଇଛି ବହୁ। ମୁଁ ଫୁଲବାଣୀର ଗୋଟେ ଉଦାହରଣ ରଖିବି, ଜଣେ ଟେଣ୍ଟ ହାଉସ୍ ମାଲିକ ଗୋଟେ ବୋର୍ଡ ଲଗେଇଛନ୍ତି, 18 ବର୍ଷରୁ କମ୍ ବୟସରେ ବିବାହ କରୁଥିବା ଲୋକ ମୋ ଦୋକାନକୁ ଆସ ନାହିଁ ବୋଲି। ତ ଏଇଭଳି ଅନେକ ଉଦାହରଣ ଅଛି, ଯେଉଁଠି ଏବେ ଦେବଗଡ଼ରେ ଜଣେ କାର୍ଡ ଛାପିଛନ୍ତି ଯେ ମୋ ଝିଅର ବିବାହ ବୟସ 18 ଉପରକୁ ବୋଲି କାର୍ଡରେ ଲେଖିଛନ୍ତି। ତ ଏଇଭଳି ଅନେକ ଉଦାହରଣ ଆମକୁ ଆଣିବାକୁ ପଡିବ, ପ୍ରଶାସନକୁ ସକ୍ରିୟ ହେବାକୁ ପଡିବ, ଏବଂ ଯେଉଁ ଚାଇଲ୍ଡ ମ୍ୟାରେଜ୍ ପ୍ରୋହିବିସନ୍ ଅଫିସର୍ସ ମାନେ ଅଛନ୍ତି ତାଙ୍କୁ ଅଧିକ ଉତ୍ତରଦାୟୀ ଆମକୁ କରିବାକୁ ପଡିବ। ଆମ ପାଖରେ ସବୁ ପ୍ରକାର ସ୍କିମ୍ ଅଛି, ଜୁଭେନାଇଲ୍ ଜଷ୍ଟିସ୍ କେୟାର ଆଣ୍ଡ ପ୍ରୋଟେକ୍ସନ୍ ଆକ୍ଟ ଅଛି, ଇଣ୍ଟିଗ୍ରେଟେଡ୍ ଚାଇଲ୍ଡ ପ୍ରୋଟେକ୍ସନ୍ ସ୍କିମ୍ ଅଛି, ବିଜୁ ଶିଶୁ ସୁରକ୍ଷା ଯୋଜନା ଅଛି। ତା ସତ୍ତ୍ୱେ ବି ଆମ ପିଲା କାହିଁକି ଶିକ୍ଷାରୁ ବଞ୍ଚିତ ହେବେ, ସୁରକ୍ଷାରୁ ଅଧିକାରରୁ ବଞ୍ଚିତ ହେବେ? ତାଙ୍କର ଅଧିକାରର ସୁରକ୍ଷା ଦିଗରେ ଆମକୁ ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କୁ ଯଦି ଲାଗିବା ତାହେଲେ ତାଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଗୋଟେ ଏନାବିଲିଂ ଏନ୍ଭିରୋନମେଣ୍ଟ ଆମେ କରିପାରିବା, ଗୋଟେ ମୁଁ କୁହେ ତାଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ସ୍ୱପ୍ନ ଦେଖିବାର ଗୋଟେ ସାହସ ଆମେ ତିଆରି କରିପାରିବା, ଏବଂ ସ୍ୱପ୍ନ ଦେଖିବାର ସାହସ ସେତେବେଳେ ତିଆରି ହେବ ଯେତେବେଳେ ସେ ତାକୁ ପୂରଣ କରିବାର ସୁଯୋଗ ସେମାନଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ଠିଆ ହେବ। ତେଣୁକରି ତାକୁ ପୂରଣ କରିବାକୁ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଭିତ୍ତିଭୂମି ଦେଇପାରିବା, ତାଙ୍କୁ ପୂରଣ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ସ୍କୁଲ ବନ୍ଦ କରିବା ନାହିଁ, ୟା ପୂର୍ବ ସେସନରେ ଆଲୋଚନା ହେଉଥିଲା, ଯଦି ସବୁ ଜାଗାରେ ସ୍କୁଲ ଗୁଡ଼ାକ ବନ୍ଦ ହେଇଯିବ ସେ କୋଉଠି ପଢିବା ପାଇଁ ଯିବେ? ଡ୍ରପ୍ ଆଉଟ୍ ହେବେ, ବାଲ୍ୟ ବିବାହ ବଢିବ, ଯେତିକି ଆମେ ଆଲୋଚନା କଲେ ବି ଆମେ ପୁଣି ଏପଟେ ମେଣ୍ଟାଲ ମୋର୍ଟାଲିଟି ରେଟ୍ ନେଇକିରି IMR MMR କୁ ନେଇକିରି ପଇସା ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ କରିବା, କିନ୍ତୁ ସେପଟେ ବାଲ୍ୟ ବିବାହ କରାଇବା। ତ ଏଇଭଳି ଯେଉଁ ସ୍ଥିତି ଅଛି ତାକୁ ଆମକୁ ଦୂର କରିକିରି ତାଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ସ୍ୱପ୍ନ ଦେଖିବାର ଗୋଟେ ସୁଯୋଗକୁ ଆମେ ଆହୁରି ପ୍ରୋତ୍ସାହିତ କରିବା, ତାଙ୍କୁ ପ୍ରୋତ୍ସାହନ ଦେବା ଏବଂ ସେଇମାନେ ହିଁ ଆଗାମୀ ଦିନରେ ଏ ଅଭିଯାନର ଧାରକ ହେବେ ଏବଂ ପରିବର୍ତ୍ତନର କାରକ ହେବେ। ବହୁତ ବହୁତ ଧନ୍ୟବାଦ, ଏଭଳି ଏକ ସୁଯୋଗ ତିଆରି ହେଇଛି ଆଜି ଆଲୋଚନା କରିବା ପାଇଁ। ଓଡ଼ିଶା ବିକାଶ କନକ୍ଲେଭର ମୁଁ ନିଜକୁ ବି ଜଣେ ଅଂଶୀଦାର ଭାବରେ ଭାବେ, ତା ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ବ୍ୟକ୍ତି ଭାବରେ ଭାବେ, ତେଣୁ ରିସୋର୍ସ ପର୍ସନ ନୁହେଁ, ବରଂ ମନର କଥା କହିବା ପାଇଁ ଏହା ଏକ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ଲାଟଫର୍ମ। ଆଜି ଏ ସୁଯୋଗ ମୋତେ ମିଳିଛି ଏବଂ ଶୁଣିବାକୁ ବି ମିଳିଲା ବହୁତ ଗୁରୁତ୍ୱପୂର୍ଣ୍ଣ ତଥ୍ୟ ଏବଂ ଉପସ୍ଥାପନା, ସେଥିପାଇଁ ଅନେକ ଅନେକ ଧନ୍ୟବାଦ।
Thank you, Ghasiram. I think after Prime Minister Narendra Modi, one or other time I'm going to jump in the light of end. But yes, but it's very important. Specifically, I'm surprised. I mean, like, our Kathav ke 300 ali marriage bond hi chhi bolii, but now it has gone up to 500 some odd. Amuha uchi number akuri, you know, like, adhika hai ki wo. Karna iti ke logon par tu, ame information pai paachi. Sabu jila re tu naam pa ke information asi nahi. ଏତିକି 500 ମୋର ଦେନ୍ 518 ମ୍ୟାରେଜେସ୍ ଆଜି ସେଟ୍ ମାନେ ବନ୍ଦ କରାଯାଇପାରୁଛି, ତେଣୁ ଆପଣ ଚିନ୍ତା କରନ୍ତୁ କେତେ ହେଇଥିବ। ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଏ ସ୍ମଲ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି,
ଏବଂ ଏହା କେବଳ 15ଟି ଜିଲ୍ଲାରେ,
କେବଳ 15ଟି ଜିଲ୍ଲା, ସୋ ଆଉ କୌଣସି ଜିଲ୍ଲା ଆମେ ଏପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ ଆଡ୍ କରିନି। ତ ଆମେ ଭାବିବା ଦରକାର ଯେ କେତେ ସିରିୟସ୍ ଏ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମଟା, ଆଉ ଏ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ ଆହୁରି ଆଗକୁ ଅଧିକା ବି ହବ। ଆଣ୍ଡ ଆମେ ମାନେ ଯଦି ଏବେଠୁ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟେଜାଇଜ୍ ନ କରିବା, ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟେଜି ଡେଭଲପ୍ ନ କରିବା ଟୁ ଆଡ୍ରେସ୍ ଦିଜ୍ ଇସ୍ୟୁଜ୍, ଡେଫିନେଟ୍ଲି ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ବି ଆନାଦର୍ ଡିଜାଷ୍ଟର। କାରଣ ଆମ ସୋସାଇଟି କେବେ ବି ଇକ୍ୱାଲ୍ ନଥିଲା ବା କେବେ ବି ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ସମାନ ସୁଯୋଗ ଦେଇନଥିଲା, ଆଉ ଏ ଯୋଉ ପ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡେମିକ୍ ଆହୁରି ଆଡଭର୍ସ କରିଛି ସିଚୁଏସନ୍। ବହୁତ ଜଣ ବିଶେଷ ଭାବରେ ମହିଳା ଆଉ ଝିଅମାନଙ୍କ ଉପରେ ଡିସ୍ପ୍ରପୋର୍ସନେଟ୍ଲି ଏହାର ଇମ୍ପାକ୍ଟ ଆସିଛି, ଆଉ ଆମକୁ ସେ ଇମ୍ପାକ୍ଟକୁ କମେଇବା ପାଇଁ ହେଲେ ତାଙ୍କ ସାଙ୍ଗରେ ନିହାତି କାମ କରିବାର ବହୁତ ଆବଶ୍ୟକତା ରହିଛି। ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ ସୋ ମଚ୍। ଅଲ୍ ଦ ପ୍ୟାନେଲିଷ୍ଟ ହାଭ୍ ଅଲରେଡି ମେଡ୍ ଦେୟାର ପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେସନ୍। ଆମେ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ସକୁ ଯିବା। ଦେୟାର ଆର୍ ସମ୍ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ ଯୋଉଟା କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ ବକ୍ସରେ ମୁଁ ଦେଖୁଛି, ତା ପୂର୍ବରୁ ନୀଲାଦ୍ରି ଡୁ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ପ୍ରଫେସର କୁଣ୍ଡୁ ଷ୍ଟିଲ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ଅସ୍, ସେ ହ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡ ରେଜ୍ କରିଥିଲେ। ତାଙ୍କୁ ପରବର୍ତ୍ତୀ ଇଏରେ କଥା ହେଇପାରିବା। ସିଟି ମାଇଟ୍ ହାଭ୍ ସମ୍ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ଅବଜର୍ଭେସନ୍ସ ଟୁ ମେକ୍ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ କୁଡ୍ ଗେଟ୍ ହିଜ୍ ଅବଜର୍ଭେସନ୍ସ ଆଟ୍ଲିଷ୍ଟ ୟୁ ନୋ ଫର୍ ଦିସ୍ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ସେସନ୍। ତ କେତେ ଗୁଡ଼େ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ସ ଥିଲା। ଆଇ ଥିଙ୍କ ମିଷ୍ଟର ବାରିକ ହାଭ୍ ଅଲରେଡି ୟୁ ନୋ ରେସ୍ପଣ୍ଡେଡ୍ ଟୁ ୟୋର୍ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍। ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଦାଟ୍ ଦ ମେନ୍ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଆଫେକ୍ଟେଡ୍ ବାଇ ଦ ପ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡେମିକ୍, ବଟ୍ ଡେଫିନେଟ୍ଲି ଦ ଇମ୍ପାକ୍ଟ ଅନ୍ ୱମେନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ମଲ୍ଟିପୋଲ୍ସ ୟୁ ନୋ ଲାଇକ୍ ମୋର୍ ଦାନ୍ ଏନି ମେନ୍। ଦ୍ୱିତୀୟ ଜିନିଷ ହେଉଛି ସୁରେନ୍ଦ୍ରଙ୍କର କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ ଥିଲା ଫର୍ ମିତାଲି ଚିନାରା, କୁଡ୍ ପ୍ରଫେସନାଲ ଚିନାରା ଇଲାବୋରେଟ୍ ମୋର୍ ଅନ୍ ଜେଣ୍ଡର ରେସ୍ପନ୍ସିବ୍ ପ୍ରୋକ୍ୟୁରମେଣ୍ଟ ଇନ୍ ପବ୍ଲିକ ୱର୍କସ୍। ଆଇ ଥିଙ୍କ ମିତାଲି ହାଡ୍ ଟ୍ରାଇ ଟୁ ୟୁ ନୋ ଗିଭ୍ ଅନ୍ ଆନ୍ସର୍ ଟୁ ଦିସ୍ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍, ବଟ୍ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ୱୁଡ୍ ଲାଇକ୍ ଟୁ ୟୁ ନୋ ଲିଟିଲ୍ ବିଟ୍ ମୋର୍ ଏମ୍ଫାସାଇଜ୍ ଅନ୍ ଦାଟ୍, ତାହେଲେ ଭଲ ହେବ। ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେନ୍ ମିତାଲି ୱୁଡ୍ ୟୁ ଲାଇକ୍ ଟୁ ଟେକ୍ ଦ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ସ?
ୟେସ୍ ୟେସ୍, ମୁଁ ସୁରେନ୍ଦ୍ର ବାବୁଙ୍କୁ କହିଛି ସେଇ କଥା ଯେ ଆମର ଆମର ଯେଉଁ ପ୍ରୋକ୍ୟୁରମେଣ୍ଟ ପଲିସି ଅଛି, ଆମେ ଯେଉଁଗୁଡ଼ା ମହିଳା ଉଦ୍ୟୋଗ ଯେଉଁଗୁଡ଼ା ଅଛି, ଯେଉଁଠି ବେଶୀ ମହିଳା ରହୁଛନ୍ତି, ଅଧିକ ମାନେ ନମ୍ବରରେ ମହିଳାମାନେ ଯେଉଁଠି କାମ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ସେଇ ଉଦ୍ୟୋଗ ଗୁଡ଼ିକୁ ଆମକୁ ପ୍ରମୋଟ୍ କରିବା ଦରକାର। କାରଣ ଆମେ ଜାଣୁଛୁ ସେମାନଙ୍କର ଜୀବନ ଜୀବିକା ଇଜ୍ ଆଟ୍ ଏ ଥ୍ରେଟ୍, ତାଙ୍କର ଜୀବନ ଜୀବିକା ପ୍ରତି ଗୋଟେ ଆସିଛି, ଗୋଟେ ଚ୍ୟାଲେଞ୍ଜ ଆସିଛି। ତେଣୁ ସେହିସବୁ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟର ଯେଉଁ ପ୍ରୋକ୍ୟୁରମେଣ୍ଟ ପଲିସି ଅଛି, ଆମର SME ପଲିସି ଅଛି ସ୍ମଲ୍ ସ୍କେଲ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରିଜ୍କୁ, ତେଣୁ ସେଇଗୁଡ଼ାର ପ୍ରୋକ୍ୟୁରମେଣ୍ଟରେ ଆମେ ଯଦି ପ୍ରାଧାନ୍ୟ ଦିଆଯାଇପାରିବ ମହିଳା ଉଦ୍ୟୋଗୀମାନଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଏବଂ ମହିଳା ଉଦ୍ୟୋଗୀ ମାନଙ୍କ ଦ୍ୱାରା ପ୍ରସ୍ତୁତ ସାମଗ୍ରୀ ପାଇଁ, ଏବଂ ଯେଉଁ ଉଦ୍ୟୋଗ ଗୁଡ଼ିକରେ ମହିଳାଙ୍କର ସଂଖ୍ୟା ଅଧିକ ସେସବୁ ଜାଗାରେ, ସେସବୁ ଜାଗା ଯଦି ପାଇବ, ତାହେଲେ ମହିଳାମାନଙ୍କର ଏମ୍ପ୍ଲୟମେଣ୍ଟର ସୁଯୋଗ ସୃଷ୍ଟି ହେବ ଏବଂ ସେମାନଙ୍କର ଜୀବିକାକୁ ପ୍ରୋତ୍ସାହନ ଦିଆଯାଇପାରିବ। ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ଜେଣ୍ଡର ରେସ୍ପନ୍ସିଭ ଇଣ୍ଟରଭେନ୍ସନ୍, ଜେଣ୍ଡର ଇଟ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅ ପଜିଟିଭ ଇଣ୍ଟରଭେନ୍ସନ୍ ଟୁ ଗିଭ୍ ପ୍ରମୋଟ ୱିମେନ୍ ଏମ୍ପ୍ଲୟମେଣ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଟୁ ପ୍ରମୋଟ ୱିମେନ୍ ଏଣ୍ଟରପ୍ରିନିୟର୍ସ ଦାଟ୍ ଟୁ।
ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ ପ୍ରଫେସର ମିତାଲି। ଆଇ ଥିଙ୍କ ସୁରେନ୍ଦ୍ର, ଡୁ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଏନି ଅଦର କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ସ ଅର୍ ଏନି ଆଡିସନାଲ ଥିଙ୍ଗ୍ସ ଟୁ ମେକ୍ ଫର୍ ପ୍ରଫେସର ଚିନ୍ହା? ଓକେ, I think Surendra also have questions to Professor Navanita Roth, that is who will do hand holding and who would do lot of training from whom to stop the domestic violence, and also he had asked if you could elaborate on the issues of entitlement of the community with regards to violence against women. Are the community aware fully about the rules and regulations on violence against women, domestic violence specifically? Professor Rath could comment on this. So, Navanita, would you like to take these questions?
Yes, there are three questions. Prathamata hella je ame community aware achi ki nahi. Prathek community re kichi na kichi domestic violence upare aware achanti ach nahanti boli nahi. Particularly ame jodi class perspective re dekhiba lower class hontu kintu higher class mane bi bahut conscious kan ame paper re padchu ye karchu kintu problem hochi aware thai ki madhyam semane niche jete bele seta ko practice karchanti semananko se awareness kam korni au bahut samay semane bhabuchanti domestic violence ta hochi gote gharoi jinsa jothre ki konosi bahar ba mane public interference darkar nahi kintu bahut samay domestic violence ra impact bartan am ta ko purely private ba bi se jo under reporting hochi under recording hochi kan रिपोर्टिंग हेले जे रेकॉर्डिंग हबो तेनो सेही जिनस रे अवेयर अछंती किंतु तांको आहुरी सचेतन करेबा पय पडिबो पर्टिकुलरली जो माने मैडम कहथले प्रज्ञा मैडम निम्न मध्यवित्त बा मध्यवित्त इमाननको आहुरी अवेयर करेबा पय पडिबो एके द्वितीय जिनस होउछि की ट्रेनिंग दबो ट्रेनिंग दबाटा एक्चुअली एटा गोटे ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम तांकर गोटे सोशलाइजेशन हुए आमी जदि डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस थ्योरी देखिबा से गोटे कहे सोशल लर्निंग थ्योरी अछि जो घरे ऑलरेडी वायलेंस होइथे तांको पिला माने से वायलेंस ता सिखि सिखि जाइथांदे तेनो जो लर्निंग अनलर्निंग बा रीलर्निंग ता सेटा नीचे आमे करिया पय पडिबो किंतु बहुत समय रे जो कम्युनिटी रे जो एनजीओ माने काम करचोंती बा यूथ ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस काम करचोंती हमर पंचायत रे भी एते वुमेन मेंबर अछंती से माने भी वायलेंस ता को टेक अप करिवा कथा तार उपरे से माने लोक मिस्त्री लोक मान कहिवा कथा जे से माने एटा रिपोर्ट करंतु जति भी एपरि किछि होउछि वायलेंस डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस से माने कम्युनिटी रे पंचायत रो भी हेल्प नियंतु पंचायत भी मध्य एतरे इंटरफेयर करि पारिबो तेनो आमे गोटे लोकलज्या बोली बहुत समय रे एटा को आमे बाहर को आनो नाही तेनो आमे सेइटा को किपरि आनिबा पुलिस रो सहायता किपरि नबा हेल्पलाइन रो सहायता नबा किंबा कोनसी काउंसलिंग सेंटर रो सहायता नबा कने काउंसलिंग माध्यम रे भी बहुत गुडे हिंसा कमा जाई पारिबो तेनो एटा मध्ये दरकार ट्रेनिंग ता तेनो गोटे लाइफ लॉन्ग ट्रेनिंग दरकार स्कूल टू मध्ये हिंसा विरोधी ये गुडी को पिला मन को कहे पय पडिबो हमर प्राइमरी रखिया पय पडिबो स्पेशल सचेतनता शिविर मध्ये करा जाई पारिबो एवं समस्त को काउंसलिंग ता आमे सेमन धीरे धीरे निजे मध्ये एटा करिबा आवश्यक रहिछि नाउ थर्ड सेंस होछि एंटाइटलमेंट केही एंटाइटल करिवेनी हमको निज को एम्पावर करिया पय पडिबो आमे बहुत समय रे एंटाइटलमेंट को आशा करी रहु हमको से माने पुलिस सहायता जगेबे हमको जगेबे किंतु आमे निजे मध्ये चाहिले जति गोटे सॉलिडैरिटी थिबो गोटे कम्युनिटी रे इवन गोटे परिवार मध्ये रे मध्ये जति गोटे दुई जना स्वामी स्त्री को भितरे केते बे गंडोल मु इंटीमेट पार्टनर वायलेंस कथा कहतली मु सेत पय कहउची तांको पिला माने तांकर थिबा जदि सीनियर के थिबे घरर एल्डरली लोक से इंटरवेन करी बहुत समय हैंड होल्डिंग से पारे एंटाइटलमेंट किए कर नुहे केवल जे ल हेले हिंसा टा कमी तार भी माने ना ल होकर हिंसा रेट आम बढ़ी जा तेणु आमको निजे को इसे सचेतन हवा पड़ो
थैंक यू प्रोफेसर नवीता फॉर दोस क्वेश्चंस एंड इन फैक्ट मिस्टर विवेक मिश्रा हैड सजेस्टेड companies like Orpat that is in Gujarat can be created here in Odisha where all the you know like all the employees and all the people who are in there are all women. It's like all women company. I take your points rightly Mr. Mishra and he suggested if you can make ecosystem suitable for women employment by creating all women employees company like Orpat. And to which I think Professor Mitali had already, you know, like given her thoughts about it. And way out is probably promoting this kind of companies. We can start probably promoting companies and organizations where we have more number of women employees, and then get into companies, it's like all women employees company, things like that. Thank you. And Ranjana has a question. In reflection in impact COVID-19 on women and girls, I was expecting more analysis from a generalist, that is not just about bias against women, but something more about breakdown of both women and men, not just in community, but there, but in middle class too, resulting out of mounted work pressure, out of unstructured work styles, demands and sitting at home, inability to efficiently manage work from home, expected support from spouse at work and household responsibility, time demand for children on everyday basis and not just evening and weekends, frustration out of inability to meet all expectations over and above the financial uncertainty ahead. Measures also need to be those that help manage relationship better while being with each other for 24 hours, because this is the new normal that is going to be there. Thank you so much, Ranjana. You have absolutely raised very valid points. And in fact, I had to intervene in between, with the speakers to manage the time. And I guess both Mithali and Navanita had highlighted on some of part of this issue, part of the aspects. Mithali, would you like to supplement something?
About what?
About the response that Ranjana has given regarding the expected support from spouse at work and household, sharing household responsibilities.
Yes, that is yes. Earlier, mane aguru amara thila gote typical फिमेल डोमिन मैंने आम भावुलु केवल घर स्त्री लोकटे कम करुचे दर आर चेंजेस हैपनिंग बट द चेंजेस आर आम गोटे बहुत जदि गोटे पुरुष लोकटे रोसे करदेला गोटे दिन गोटे एड आसूला आप देखिथे जदि गोटे पुरुष लोकटे गोटे दिन रोसे कला दैट इज अ लॉट ऑफ आई मीन अप्रिसीएशन फॉर दैट बट इफ अ वुमन डज इट इट्स टेकन फॉर ग्रांटेड यू हैव डन इट बिकॉज यू आर सपोज टू डू इट सो आई डोंट डिसएग्री दैट वुमेन हैव टू डू द केयर गिविंग वर्क for growth as I have pointed out, for nurturing the future generation of labor or the caregivers or what you say out to nurturing of the future generation is primarily the woman's job, but the men have to share, the men have to share because women are sharing their burden. Aguru kohutile purusha loka mane bahar ku jibe breadwinners, they are the breadwinners, but kathala je bartaman jehetu semane bahar ku jauchanti kama karuchanti sei bhali parimanare semananku sahanubhuti rahiba darkar ebong se sahanubhuti ta should not come as a gote daya hisabare nuhe, rather it should be our entitlement, it should be our entitlement, like so it is an equal world. जे जदि मु काम करुछि बाहर को जाउछि बाहर आसला परे मते जेमति घरे विश्राम दरकार आई वांट रेस्ट आई वांट टू हैव आई वांट टू आई आल्सो नीड टू बी टेकन केयर ऑफ समवन आई आल्सो वांट दैट समवन शुड गिव मी अ कप ऑफ टी इफ आई एम गिविंग अ कप ऑफ टी एट सम पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम यू शुड आल्सो गिव मी अ कप ऑफ टी दैट चेंज इन मेंटल सेटअप इज कमिंग एंड वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट प्रॉब्लम हला आमे आमो झियो पई सेटा आमो ज्वाई कले आमे सेटा को ग्रहण करूछु किंतु आमो पुओ आमो बहु पई कले आमे सेटा को ग्रहण करू नाहु सेई जो तफातटा आमे देखुछु सम इट इज अ सोशल कंडीशनिंग इट्स अ सोशल कंडीशनिंग व्हिच विल चेंज इट इज चेंजिंग बट एज इन केस ऑफ एनी सोसाइटल नॉर्म एनी सोसाइटल सेट एनी सोसाइटल काइंड ऑफ वैल्यू सिस्टम इट इज टेकिंग टाइम बट इट शुड चेंज क्वाइट फास्ट दिस घरे रहिबा परे ए जिंसटा काम करिबा व्हेन दैट इज वर्तमान मु देखुची घरे रही कि काम करिवार गोटे डिसएडवांटेज हैला यू डोंट हैव एनी पर्सनल टाइम द प्रोफेशनल टाइम पर्सनल टाइम पूरा मार्ज करिगला तमे राति 8टा 9टा 10टा पर्यंत काम करिया को पडुची दैट इज नो पर्सनल टाइम सो सेही केस रे हमकु टिक 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 छिटा आमो संगरे हाथ रे हाथ मिसाइबा हेले मध्य गोटे सोसाइटी टाको आगो सोसाइटी आगो को बढ़िबो एवं मु खुशी हेले मो घर खुशी हबो ए जिंसटा निहाती दरकार सो ए हैप्पी होम नीड्स बोथ द कोऑपरेशन ऑफ द मैन एंड द वाइफ थैंक यू
सो थैंक यू मिताली एंड रंजना दिस इज समथिंग यू नो लाइक आमे माने समस्त ही फेस करछे एज यू सेड यस वी ऑल आर वर्किंग फ्रॉम होम एंड देन वी नो व्हाट इज द काइंड ऑफ प्रेशर दैट वी हैव यू नो लाइक अस maybe ame mane kete jano seta ko koi to overcome kari parche or like we have that kind of you know support system with us or that kind of you know like articulation but there are many who cannot actually you know cope with that I have actually counted number of cases during this lockdown period. Duty stri loko mane ghare kaam karuchanti and they are also expected ki samastanko khaiba paniki debe on time samastanko pai you know like sab jinsa taiyari kari rakhithibe including the husband je bhi kaam karuchanti ghar bhitare. So there is a lot of problem that had happened, and you have in fact very rightly pointed out about the relationship management. And there are a number of, you know, like counselors who have actually come up for the relationship management. The relationship, they have been called as the relationship counselor. I think the pandemic has taught us to look into this. It is small, chutiya chutiya jinsa guda karchi ta bhitare yaku dekhiba pai gote scope actually amaku deichi this pandemic. So as we always, you know, like have been saying, disaster also brings opportunity. So this has also, you know, like given an opportunity for all of us to look into all those kind of problems and see the kind of support system that we have in place. And if it is not there, then demand for those kind of support system, you know, create opportunity to have those support systems in place. A relationship manager counseling the amara both in Odisha re counseling you know bahut kam achi mane professional counselors bahut kam achanti kind of similar demand with the community asina, but there is an opportunity. ये जो समय रे जते मन डिमांड आसुची तो डेफिनेटली वी कैन थिंक ऑफ डेवलपिंग अ कैडर ऑफ पीपल दोज हु कुड एक्चुअली गेट इनटू दोस काइंड ऑफ काउंसलिंग. आई कैन से दैट आई कैन ऐड ऑन टू यू नो लाइक व्हाट प्रोफेशन में तारी एंड प्रोफेशन अमृता हैज से इन आंसरिंग टू रंजना. थैंक यू. या आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड योर फ्रस्ट्रेशन रंजना. या सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ऑल दोस क्वेश्चंस. यदि आपका और किसी प्रश्न था and then in fact there are some people who had raised their hand. Mr. Samsudin, is he still there or we have lost him? He has lost the connection. Sheikh Samsudin had raised his hand for quite a long period of time along with Professor Kudus. I thought if I could get back to him. Amma pakhe Ramesh Chandra Das Achanti, then Evangeli, both of them have raised their hands. Jehetu tankara questions asi nahi. Can we you know give them some speaking option, Niladri, please? Ramesh Chandra Das, thank you for unmute.
Yes. We have given them speaking option. They can unmute their mic and speak.
Okay, yeah, please Mr. Das, apna unmute karo to nijaku and keep your questions, and very shortly because we are almost like, you know, like killing other time. Mr. Ramesh Chandra Das, can you unmute? Yeah, please keep your questions. Apana kar prashna rakhantu Mr. Das, apana unmute kari chanti kuantu.
Hello,
ha kuantu aja.
Hello,
kuantu ami suni parchu apanku kuantu.
Nahi connection asuni aja.
आपण आमको अपन देखि पार नथिबे आमे कि आपन को कथा सुनि परजु आपन को प्रश्न रखंतु.
नै प्रथम प्रश्न होची जो अनलॉक टाइम रे जो प्रकार जो डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस को कथा कहउथले तार किमिति निराकरण पे कोन स्ट्रेटजी रहियो जेंति फर्दर प्रश्न ता गोटे पेंडेमिक हेला सोटा जेंति न होबो सेत पे कोन आमे प्रस्तुत रहिया किमिति.
ओके थैंक यू. मु भावुच्छे आम प्रश्न नहीं जापर पानेलीस्ट मान पाखक जावांजलि आपज को अनम्यूट कर प्लीज हाव योर क्वेश्चंस.
एंड आई कैन आई ऑडिबल.
Yes,
yeah. Please go ahead. Outside, look, I'd like to congratulate all the panelists for such wonderful session. In fact, I don't have a question, a particular question. Rather, I would like to add some points. Just everyone has addressed on different aspects of women's problem, whether it is the economic impact of women or the feminization of poverty, impact of domestic violence from intimate partners, child marriage, whatever every aspects of you know women's problem. Everything is we see everything is interrelated, and one factor supplement or complements the other factor. And the pandemic, in fact, the pandemic, already the panelists told the indirectly, the pandemic doesn't have any gender. rather the pandemic, pandemic may trigger its impact. But already, whatever the problems have already, it has already been there from time immemorial, and it is existed.
I think you actually caught in short, Dr. Ramanjali. I think so, some of our panelists have to.
Okay, the one underlining thing, what I'm trying to say, one underlying thing is the mindset. The mindset, the socio-cultural practices, what? That one important factor, what helped to this mindset is the important point is the sense of ethical, the sense of ethics or the ethical ethical
points.
And spirit.
I think we got the point what you were trying to say. I need to actually close this question and answer sessions over here because all our panelists are actually, need to leave. And before that, we have to definitely thank them, officially because it is absolutely, like an emergency situation, and that kind of they agreed to come. And what a wonderful deliberation all of us, like all of them had. It is definitely time to acknowledge all their contribution to this conclave and also to the discourse. So without making much delay, waiting for all of you, can I request Madam Pramila Swai, convener of National Alliance of Women Odisha Chapter, to propose a formal vote of thanks to all our panelists. Pramila, please on karantu apanakar camera and also,
Samastanku namaskar. Amar aji sabu panelist manaku sunila pare ebong sabu जो माने जॉइन करचंदी सेमानकर प्रश्न उत्तर देखला परे मने पडची जे घर भितरे गंडगळ हेउ बा आमो गां रे गंडगळ हेउ बा आमो सामाजिक स्तर रे हो बा जातिगत हो बा धर्मगत हो जे कोनसी जगह रे गंडगळ बा हिंसा हेले महिलांक पर प्रभाव पड़े जदी आमे प्राकृतिक विपर्जय हो बा युद्ध हो बा जहां भी देखु सेथिरे महिला मानक उपरे सबटु बड़ प्रभाव पड़े आज जदी आमे समस्त आलोचना करबा एवं ए जो पेंडेमिक सिचुएशन देखिबा सब क्षेत्र में देखु आमे महिला माने का सब प्रकार हिंसार शिकार होचंती अर्थनैतिक अव्यवस्था शिकार होचंती एवं से माने सब प्रकार कष्ट सही चंती एटा नुह जे अन्य माने सही नंती किंतु आमे जदी गभीर भाव रे आलोचना कले एवं आमर जो पैनलिस्ट माने आमको जो दिग्दर्शन देले तांकर स्टडी तांकर अनुभव से अनुसार तो सही हिसाब रे आमे देखिबा जे महिला मानकर स्थिति बहुत खराब अवस्था को आसीची एवं आजर ए जो वेबिनार किभली आवश्यकता थिला सेटा मध्ये जणा पडुची तनो ओ जो जेते कम समय मध्ये रे खाली दीपहर रे एटा डिसाइड करिकिरी डाकिला परे प्रकृत रे स्नेहबा जो कहले जेते कम समय तरे हमर पैनलिस्ट मान पई समय दैचंती सेथि पई मु नेशनल अलायंस ऑफ वुमेन आइना एवं ओडिसा डेवलपमेंट कॉन्क्लेव तरफ समस्त को हार्दिक शुभेच्छा दौर धन्यवाद जनाऊँ एत भल भाव को अपडेट कर विशेषकर मिताली मैडम को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देवी तांकर जो सुंदर प्रेजेंटेशन से एते कम समय भितर निजे कहते हैं बहुत भाव बहुत भाव बहुत भल भाव जो से प्रेजेंट कले के परिमाण में जो मैंने कि इनफर्माल सेक्टर में काम कर सब जो मैंने घरे बस काम कर जो मैंने कि सबुठ बे कौ चाक्रिया मैंने से मानने एफेक्टेड होना जो जो मैंने कंपानी काम करफेक्टेड ही ना तो घरे बस वर्क फ्रम होम कर पैसा पाई कि प्रकृत में 70-80% महिला जो मैंने कि इनफर्माल सेक्टर में काम कर विभिन्न होम मेड बिजनेस कर सबुठ बे अर्थनैतिक दुरावस्थार शिकार होती आई से जो केत गुड प्रस्ताव जमती सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ को गुरुत्व दि जाऊ इकोनॉमिक रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी को रेस्पॉन्स को सब जेंडर लेंस रे देखा जाऊ एवं सोशल प्रोटेक्शन व्यवस्था हो बहुत गुड भल सजेसन देखते मैडम कर ये प्रेजेंटेशन से और जो समय दे पूरा तैयारी आरंभ कर आज आम सहित क्वेश्चन आसमु बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद निश्चित भाव देवी समस्त तरफ रुछड़ा नवनीता मैडम सी विशेषकर जो डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस कौली भाव में बढ़ी आ गोटे बहुत बड़ कथा कहले निश्चित भाव में डोमेस्टिक भायोलेंस बहुत परिमाण में बढ़ी किंतु सेटा नुहे जे खाली कोविड पई बढ़ी आमर जो सामाजिक एवं सांस्कृतिक व्यवस्था से जो मानसिकता सेटा मध्ये बहुत कारण है आउ सेटा मध्ये को बढ़ेबार बहुत माने भूमिका ग्रहण करछन्ति आउ ताको केमिति कमाई हेबो ता पई मध्ये चेष्टा करबा दरकार तांकर वक्तव्य से रखछन्ति तांको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देबी मैडम नवनीता मैडम को आउ प्रज्ञा मैडम प्रमाणित करदेले जे प्रकृत रे आमे जहा कहुछु सेटा तथ्यर मध्य रहिछि जे को भली भाबरे महिलांक पर हिंसा बढ़ुछि सुंदर भाबरे कहले जे 3 वर्ष रेकर्ड देखिले एवं ए जो 3 मास रु 6 मास जो रेकर्ड देखिले से भितरे को भली भाबरे बढ़िछि महिलांक पर हिंसा से सुंदर भाबरे कहले एवं ताठो बड़ कथा मध्य सेइथिरे जो सब लैकिंग अछि जेमते से कहले जे आमे खाली करूथुलु माने काउंसलिंग टा करि पारथुलु किंतु जेतिक पुलिस रो सहयोग करिवा कथा जे अन्यन सपोर्ट सर्विस तांकु जो दबा कथा सेतिक संभव हौ नथिला आउ सेटा हबा दरकार थिला आमे मध्ये अनुभव करिचु जे जेंती आमे सब सपोर्ट सेंटर सब एसपी ऑफिस रे थिला सब एसपी ऑफिस मना कले के एठी से वर्तमान सपोर्ट सर्विस दिया हि परिबन तो सेटा मध्ये गोटे बहुत गुरुत्वपूर्ण काम जोटा कि बंद कर दिया गला एसेंशियल सर्विस सब लिया गला नै तो से कथा मध्ये प्रज्ञांक प्रेजेंटेशन जणा पडला से माने जदियो 24 आवर्स सहाय्य करूथिले फोन कॉल रिसीव करथिले किंतु जो परिमाण रे महिलांक पाखरे सहयोग पहुंचिया करबा हुए तो पहुंचि पारिनी सेटा मध्ये से अनुभव करचंती किंतु तांकर काउंसलिंग व्यवस्था से माने करचंती घासीरांग भाई तांकर जो शिशु कन्या बा गर्ल चाइल्ड विवाह जो होय बंद करचंती स्नेहपात कहिले जे 500 रु अधिक माने चाइल्ड मैरिज बंद करिया किछु रे कम कथा नहु एवं काठो अधिक मध्ये हुए तो तांकरी अंचल रो लोक करथिबे अन्य माने करथिबे जार हिसाब आम पाखरे नाही आउ बड़ कथा घासीराम भाई कहिले जे ई सब तांको सेमानकर जो चेष्टा ए भितरे जो कोविड सिचुएशन भितरे जो चेष्टा करचंदी सरकार को भितरे जो तत्परता बढ़ी दुई तीन टा अभियान कथा कहिले जोटा चली विभिन्न जिले में आरंभ हो सरकार निष्पत्ति नौ चाइल्ड मैरिज बंद करने से गुड़िक कार्यकारी हो बहुत बड़ पदक्षेप सब बड़ कथा से कहले आम पर दृढ़ करवा सिस्टम को आम संवेदनशील करा प्रकृत सब जगार आम देखीचु सिस्टम टा संवेदनशील नुहे बोल कर महिला हिंसा हौ बालिका कन्या हिंसा हौ बा चाइल्ड मैरेज हो जेकोनसी विषय से मानने से सुजोग लोक पहुंची पारुनि तार सुविधा से पारना तेणु सब क्षेत्र को जब आम देखा सिस्टम रमी सिस्टम टा के ठीक हम और सिस्टम के संवेदनशील हम ताकि चेष्टा कर दरकार यहाँ प्राय समस्ते समस्त वक्तव्य कहते तेणु मु देखुली जे पार्टिसिपेशन व्यवस्था पाखापाखि 100 रु 130 जन ए पार्टिसिपेट करुले जाऊ आसुले मुझे देखुली समस्त आग्रह शेष पर्यटन 2 घंटा धरी समस्ते जो भाव आक्टिवली पार्टिसिपेट कर प्रतिनिधि मैंने जो मैंने पार्टिसिपेट कर समस्त को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देवी आउ ये आमर ओडिशा डेवलपमेंट कनक्लेव चली आउ एटा कंटिन्यू करिवो ए भीतर आमे बहुत गुडे रास्ता बा बहुत गुडे कार्यक्षेत्र तयारी करिवा जोटा कि महिला मानक पई आम सामाजिक व्यवस्था को दृढ़ करिवा पई भलो आड़क गति करिवा पई भलो उदाहरण सृष्टि करिवा पई निश्चित सहाय करिवो तेणु आपण मानक समस्त को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आउ आमे आशा करछु आपण माने एमती आम संगे रहिबे आउ आमे महिला को रो जो संवेदनशील इशू सब अच्छी ताको आमे दूर करिया पे चेष्टा करिबा धन्यवाद समस्त
थैंक यू सो मच प्रमिला अपा थैंक यू ऑल द पैनलिस्ट प्रोफेसर मिताली प्रोफेसर नवनीता घासीराम प्रज्ञा वंडरफुल डेलिब्रेशन एंड इंपैक्ट इतने कम समय भीतर आपण माने निजर समस्त प्रस्तुत करी के डेलिब्रेशन हम सामने रखिथिले एने बहुत जण आपण माने रिक्वेस्ट करी छेंती ई जो प्रेजेंटेशंस आपण मन पाको पठेबा पई it will be made available with Niladri and other colleagues at CYST. So, माने जो ODI रो साइटिस्ट आपको अपलोड कर दे पर भी और यदि आपन मन करो पर्सनली ईमेल आईडी अच्छी so they might be even like sending it to you. Definitely all these presentations इटा treasure खाली में इट आम मन का समस्त ना reference points. So all the panelists also agreed to share that presentation with you. तो आपन मन का पाकर presentation यहाँ पे आप रह जिएगा. आमे ये कार्यक्रम को एठी सारी बा.